SB Killer. SB Killer. SB Killer. SB Killer.
What it should be, it's your boy N-A-O-N-A-A.
What up, it's DJ EFN.
And this drink chest, motherfucker, yappy hour. Make some noise! And right now, when we started the show, EFN, we said we wanted, there's radio stations and there's other podcasts for, you know, up and coming and new people. But we wanted to interview legends. We wanted to interview seasoned people. We wanted to interview people who have this luxurious long list of stories and just of being a part of the game. This is not only a hero, but a hometown hero. She has dominated music, then went on and, you know, dominated radio, which was a very hard field, not only for a black woman, but for a woman, period, at that time. Then, you know, now she got a podcast too and everything. I think she's on episode, I forget what episode, but I'm checking it out. She got E-Ro down with them. I did not notice, but in case you don't know who we talking about, we talking about the motherfucking illustrious Miss Motherfucking Joe. So I
was wondering who you was talking about.
No. So you know, because what's been going on? What's been going on with you lately?
First off, I brought gifts.
Okay. Wow. Okay.
So look. Okay. This is...
It's gonna fuck me up juice. That's what it looks like.
It is.
Okay.
It's Ingenious Gin.
Okay, Ingenious Gin.
Yes.
Ooh, now, Snoop got in the glow. This is not in the glow.
No.
Oh, no, this is something different.
This is out the glow.
Okay, out the glow. Good looking.
And it's infused with lavender.
You got an atom on there. You know it's gonna work.
Yeah. It looks sexy. So, it looks sexy, yes.
Yeah.
The perfect. Thank you. Let's just take it right from the beginning, right? Because... At first, it was an artist. It was about being an artist, right? So, how, listen, for people that don't know, Astoria Projects is one of the craziest places in the world, not just Queens, in the world. So, take us from there, coming from Astoria.
So, I was, you know, always singing in the house, always trying to do talent shows and things like that. And eventually, I wound up going to high school for it, taking it seriously, and then I went to Syracuse University for it.
So you went to art schools, like to the high school?
Yeah. I went to the Fame School, Music and
Art. Oh, really?
LaGuardia.
Oh, dope.
Yeah, amazing experience.
Right.
But all they taught you was really classical singing, and I always wanted to be R&B.
Right.
So when I graduated, I met Ron G.
Wow.
Yeah.
Legendary.
Woo, yeah. Uh-huh. And so I started singing on his mixtapes. And at that time...
I started hearing you on
that. Yeah, it was new. Nobody was doing it. It was a smooth out...
The beginning of hip-hop R&B.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. So let me ask you something. Because I just seen Trick Daddy, right? Trick Daddy is going viral because Trick Daddy said Beyonce can't sing. Right? And it reminded me of something I thought I heard you say.
Ooh.
I thought I heard you say we Mary J. Blige can't sing.
They start early.
In the beginning and you go,
okay, here we go.
Okay.
So here's
I immediately
thing.
Thought of you. I'm so sorry. I immediately thought of you when
it's
he said
all good.
That. Okay.
So here's my thing.
Let me get a glass.
Technically, maybe Mary's not the most perfect singer. Who the fuck is?
Right.
My issue with Mary, because everybody knows that I've had an issue, and I'm realizing now it probably shouldn't be at Mary as much as it should be towards Diddy.
Okay.
Because when Ron and I started this whole mixtape singing
on... And when you're saying Ron, we're still on Ron G.
Ron G, right.
Ron G. Okay, cool.
That was how we got our deal with Stepson Records.
Okay.
The whole album was that.
Okay. Singing on hip... So people understand who don't know. Singing on hip-hop beats.
Right.
Right.
Which this wasn't normal at the time.
It wasn't normal at the time.
Right.
Mary's first album, if you remember, was all like jazzy songs, a couple of dance songs, but it was remixed to the sound remixing. Like a mixtape.
Yep. Mm.
Diddy had gone to Ron and asked Ron to do my stuff for Mary.
Wow.
Ron said no because Jonesy's my Miss Jones is my artist and that's the style I'm using for her.
Right.
Diddy went behind his back. Like they just recently started speaking again.
Wow. Ron G and Diddy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, okay, okay. Damn.
Yeah.
This is an untold story. I didn't know this one.
Yeah,
this
so he took the whole style and because you know my label Stepson, they didn't have a lot of money. They didn't have a
they
lot of
money. They was under Tommy Boy, wasn't they?
Yeah, okay. But really, really under. And what's the label? Whatever label, MCA, whatever.
He was on Motown though, right?
Eventually. That was later. That was later. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, a whole lot of lawsuits later. But so, Uptown had the money. MCA had the money, and they already had proven success. So it's just like put it in the machine and let's just keep it rolling. So they actually beat us to the punch, and so I always wound up looking like I was trying to sound like her.
Wow.
But the people in the streets know. The people that are the mixtape heads know. Yeah. And now that I'm back out. Mm-hmm. Like, they're really, really feeling away, and they're like, you need to get your recognition and your flowers for that. And yeah, it didn't work out musically. You flipped it and did it in radio, but fuck that. Right. So,
was there any time like that you tried to get somebody for a feature in music? And then they fronted on you, but then they had to come back and see your ass at the radio station.
That must have been fun. I like your question.
Pour her up, please. Yeah, pour her up. We're not playing. We're not playing today. I'm excited to have you here, by the way.
No,
just so you know. So has it ever
I'm
been,
glad to be here.
Has there ever been somebody who, like, you reached out, you said, yo, let me get it on the record. They didn't get on the record for whatever reason, and then they came back to the radio station and either needed a favor or how was that?
Or how about someone I slept with and wanted a feature and thought I like this.
And you had beef with and wanted a feature?
Okay. And I mean, so I would have slept with him anyway, just to be clear. He wasn't like an asshole like that.
Right.
Busta. Busta, you already know. But to his defense, I was never like considered a hot R&B artist. And at that time, they wanted heat matches heat. Mm. So he would go get with Jhené and do a song. And I'm like, am I not doing it hard enough? Right. Like, what can I do to get to...
I wasn't ready.
He would come. So later on, when I'm like rocking and radio, I was kind, but it wasn't just Busta Rhymes is coming up tomorrow. No, he's not. We'll get back and let Busta know when Busta can come. Busta, you probably didn't know that. But I love him still. But yeah, that's the one that comes to mind immediately.
Right, because you did write about him in the book. I did hear about that, but. Okay,
move. You read my book.
This is getting a little awkward for me. I didn't know this was going to go
there. We didn't have one drink in yet.
No, I told you.
Yo, for real. Let's
start.
I'm going to take some marijuana shot right
now. Take a shot. I'm with a shot.
Okay.
I'm going to start with a shot. Then hold on. I got, it's my drink.
I want to start with the shot, too.
Okay. That's what I'm talking about.
Right there.
That's the story I need.
Right next to you.
No, I need a shot glass.
No, I'm saying her bottle. I want to put this one here for display.
Thank you. Good. Boom. I'm going to take a shot out. I'm watermelon. I'm gonna do a watermelon.
Oh.
I'm gonna do a watermelon because I'm gonna start off slow. But I'm, you know what I mean? Oh my God, this guy. Real from the beginning. So, another thing is.
Not another thing is.
I think the first time I ever heard Stephen A. Smith on the actual radio was actually your show.
Yeah.
Donnell Rowland. First time I ever heard of him on the radio. It's your show. Like, she really needs, I got a whole list.
Yeah.
So how is that to see, you know, first off, what did Stephen A. Smith get to do to get on the Mix Jones show?
He was just an amazing, so he was writing for the Philadelphia paper. And
so
I was
the Philly airwaves, right?
No. So.
Wow, you know what's crazy? I automatically thought it was New York because both of y'all from Queens.
No, but it was when I got fired from Philly and came back to Hot 97.
Okay.
But I remembered him from writing on the Philly papers from when I was down in Philly.
Right.
And he was always like an amazing writer. Right. And always had these great relationships, like, behind the scenes with the... So when we were looking for a co-host, I didn't want to go normal co-host comedian route. I wanted somebody that could bring a different... And he's very opinionated, if you haven't noticed.
Right. So let me ask you, so was Stephen A. at the time, was he a sports commentator or he wasn't? He was just a commentator, period.
I think he... I don't know if he was a sports commentator, but I know he wasn't to the level of which he has become.
Of course
you know what I mean?
Right.
And so we brought him on, but it was great because he could talk about everything. He could talk about the music, and he's from Queens. And so he talks about life issues, and it was great. But he always wanted that sports thing was his thing.
Wow.
And Hot probably wasn't going to pay him... what he would have wanted.
And you know, he's the, I believe he's the most paid sportscaster.
Really?
There is now. Did you ever see, did you see that coming from the beginning? On ESPN? Is it just ESPN or just? ESPN. On ESPN, okay, my bad. I thought it was
Mad. It's still big.
It's still big.
So did you see that coming?
I did not, because you know what I remember
that's
about him?
That's modest of you to say that.
Okay. I didn't, because he's very humble in that he never got rid of that house in Willenboro.
Right.
And he always said, I'm never letting this go, this house go, because you just never know.
Right.
And I just thought that was like real. That's like, that's how we, when we grow up, the way we grow up, you always holding on to that.
Right.
But also, he has a an incredible work ethic.
Right.
So I'm not surprised.
Right.
And I'm happy for him. He and I interviewed Rick James the day before he died.
Wow.
Wait a minute, let's take the shot. Hold on, hold on.
Yeah.
We love Rick James stories.
Hold on.
Oh, do you?
Yeah, we love Rick James stories. Hold on, okay, wait a minute. You and Stephen A, I can't even picture this, by the way. Because I'm picturing, I can't imagine who Stephen A was. I can only picture who I wake up every day right now.
Mm-hmm.
So, now bring us to the time. It's you, Stephen A, and obviously this is not Zoom. This is in person.
This is at Hot 97.
Yeah. Okay, and
actually, Rick James, was he in the studio? Was he? I think he was on the phone from L.A.
Okay, there we go.
But he was like...
He was on cocaine through the phone. Through the phone, you can tell he's on cocaine.
Let's and we loved it.
He said the day before he died.
Either the day or 2 days. Or,
right.
What I remember is the next day, I was in A.C., and Stephen called me with the news and was like, we just interviewed this nigga. Right. He did not sound like he... I mean, how do you sound?
Right, yeah, yeah, true.
But we were like, and I said, you realize that's a forever moment for us, me and you?
Right.
And he was like, it's a fucked up moment, but you're right, that will go down in the books.
Yeah.
So we might have even done Rick James's final interview, and I never went back to Ebro or Hot 97 to say, is it archived? Because life goes on, people move on, you know.
Wow.
People die every day.
And that's legendary, just to talk to Rick James.
Yeah, and it was just another day on the show for us.
Right.
And you just never know. That's amazing.
Wow. Impactful.
What was your at Hot? What was your first? What was your favorite interview?
When Nas and when Summer Jam, when Jay-Z did whatever he did. I can't even remember because I drink so much.
I remember this perfectly. Go ahead. Keep going.
And Angie and Flex would not let. Well, I guess the station was told, do not let Nas. Allegedly, the station had said, don't let Nas come up there bashing Jay.
Well, the rumor was it was Mike Kaiser. Do you remember Mike Kaiser? Oh, y'all had something going on, right?
No.
Okay.
Just that I reached out for a sponsorship and was promised one, and I'm still waiting, Mike.
Okay, all right, cool. Let's get to this shit. Let's go. All right, continue.
And Kaiser had a heavy hand in what...
That was the rumor. The rumor was that Nas was going to come out, and Mike Kaiser had people set up to... He's supposed to hang Jay-Z.
Damn.
He's supposed to hang
I
him.
Remember.
This was in the middle of the war. I have no factual proof. Remember, I said the rumor
you mean like
is.
An image of that.
No, they was going to hang like a dummy of him. So the rumor has it was Def Jam, Mike Kaiser was the corporate. That's my man. Me and him is great.
Yeah, you know we're all good.
But
that, Mike
the rumor has it was he had people set up to pull the plug. So if Nas was to be able to do that, so that's the rumor. Did you hear that rumor?
So
or no?
I don't know. I did hear the rumor of the new sing. I don't know if that was even Nas's play.
Okay.
But what I do know is that whatever transpired that night, Nas was insulted, and no one would give him an outlet.
And he went to Power.
He might have, but he came to me.
Oh, okay.
I'm always the black sheep of Hot 97.
All right.
And so when Angie's like, no, I can't do that. And Flex is like.
Oh, yeah, because he dissed Angie, too. Okay, but continue. I
so that was my, I think, for just off top.
And this was in person.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, he came to Hot 97.
I let him come.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I let him come.
He was the only one where he was the black sheep. You was the black sheep. He was basically bad. He went to another stage and said, fuck them.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
But and I let him use my, because he was frustrated and, come on, that's QB. I'm a Astoria. Come on. Please get the money.
So let's just describe this interview. So he's pissed off. He didn't get a chance to perform at Summer Jam.
Right.
He goes to this other station. He says whatever. But now this is his first time explaining himself to not only you, but to the tri-state area and New York. So what was his explanation why he didn't come?
Remember, I think at that point he was in shock. I was in shock, and I think his mind was just spinning about what his reaction should be. You know, Nas is very. Very, I don't want to say calculating, but he's a thinker.
Mm-hmm.
He's not a reactive person.
As it
might seem like he's just reacting, he's always got the next three steps ahead. So he's talking, but he's still keeping it cool.
Like a chess player.
The best chess player. So no one knew the ether was coming. No one knew.
No one knew that. Were you at Hot 97 when the dad battled the beast between ether and Takeover?
I was.
You were?
I was.
Can you describe that?
I mean, niggas took sides.
Right.
Everybody was...
K-Slade clearly made his choice that he was on Nas' side. He was on...
Because K is my people. Like, me and K, when I used to not show up for my Sunday night show, I would call him to fill in.
Wow.
So I feel like me and him, we saw things alike.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, no disrespect to anybody at the station, because I love and adore Flex and Angie. Mm-hmm. Flex started me in radio, so to speak.
Right.
Produced one of those mixtape songs on my very first album that was never released. So I have love. But they had their loyalty, and rightly so. You know, I don't know what their relationship with Jay was, but clearly it was solid and, you know, accounted for. And I had mine for Nas. Because Nas, had it not been for Nas talking to me, I wouldn't have done the Sugar Hill record.
Sugar Hill, AZ record.
Not to mention, we used to hang, like we used to go out there and just be on the benches, you know what I mean? When he was in town. But even after that, when he became huge, he never acted huge to me. He always was like, come here, Jonesy, what you doing?
Wow, this is great history right here. This is great history.
Yeah, it's a lot. I don't even realize, you know how you don't realize that it's history?
Right.
Because you're just...
You're in it, you're in it.
Right!
Yeah, you're in it.
And let's not let it fly over people's heads. You're talking about AZ, Sugar Hill.
Yes.
Classic record.
Oh yeah, thank you.
Yeah, it's classic record.
Yeah,
classic
biggest record of my career.
So, all right, so you do this interview after this. Now, how is your co-workers? Because, how are they salty? Let's just be clear. Because Nas is not just a regular interview. Like, he is... It's this time it's him and Jay. So, how is it coming to work the next day? Is your coworker saying, Miss Jones, you ain't loyal? Or?
They always felt I was. Okay. Everyone knows I'm crazy.
Okay.
Everybody knows. When Wendy and Angie had the fight, I picked Wendy's side.
They really literally had a fight? Fist fight?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
I mean, it was a lot of windmilling. Okay. And but...
I can't picture this. Wendy and...
You know the vending machine that used to be outside the room?
Yeah.
It was right over there.
Get out of here. Right before the bathroom.
Yes.
Okay. Cool.
So to the point, I was forced to take a side from the moment I got in that building.
Right. And at that time...
Sound like some high school shit.
No, I mean, at that time, let me just tell you something. And God bless, because I don't want this to sound crazy, but we actually needed Power 105 because it was like, Hot 97 had... I don't want to say too much power because...
Like a monopoly on shit.
Broke
they, were
it wasn't
Putin.
They were Putin.
They were Putin? Hot 97 was Putin.
If it wasn't for Hot 97, it probably wouldn't be no me. So what I'm trying to say is, but it wasn't no balance. What I mean is... If I did something wrong or something, I would just be bad.
Right.
And that was it. It wouldn't have nothing. Like, so did you think at one point that, like, the station was just too powerful? Because it was really the truth. At one point, if Flex didn't play your record, you were dead. If Clue didn't, you had a chance. Maybe Clue would.
Right. Clue, maybe.
But and Clue only had the Monday Night mixtape. It was only one day a week.
Right.
So did you think that it was too much power at that time?
Absolutely.
Okay, all right.
They didn't hardly play my shit.
Right. You worked for the station.
And I worked there.
Right.
But the rules are the rules.
Right.
You either get out or lay down. And so, not for nothing, when Power 105 started...
Right.
3 weeks prior, or like a month prior, I had just gotten fired off of Star and Buc Wild.
Why?
So I was excited at the prospect of a Power 105.
Wow. Mm.
And I was in conversation with my former boss from Hot, who started Power, Steve Smith.
Okay, yes.
Big shout out to Steve.
Yeah.
And And we were in conversation about me coming across the street and shocking New York with, yeah, she's fired from Star and Buc, but now she's doing this over here. But I had a non-compete.
And the flaws in your contract?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. So I can't work in New York because it's too close to Hot 97. Power was too close. And so they threatened to sue. They were looking. Hot 97 was looking. Because they didn't like when Power came into the market.
Right.
They didn't know.
Yeah, you could tell.
Yeah. I think there was even something about not stolen, but a hijacked URL.
Wow.
I think, please don't, if I'm wrong, I think we might have gotten the power105.com URL. I believe.
What?
You remember, right? So, yeah. So, okay, yeah. So we were,
Okay, oh wow, damn, this guy real, okay. Alright, so Nah, okay.
But why'd you get fired from Star and Buc?
That's my question. Alright,
so
that's how I know we work together
sharing.
Great. yeah, let's give it, I got another shot too. Come on, let's go.
Let's do it, let's rock.
Let's go, okay. Yeah, because this is alright, let's just be clear to people who don't know. Star and Buc Wild was the wildest show at the time.
Wildest.
They were doing shit. They did an Aaliyah skit. We'll ask about that. You ain't had nothing to do with the Aaliyah skit, right?
I was there in the room, and that was the beginning of my firing, but I didn't. I mean, I kind of knew. I had to pick a side.
Right. So let's take a shot, and then we're going to talk about that. Okay, boom. Salud.
Yeah.
Salud. Come on, guys. Good. So what we were saying, okay, Star and Buc, how did you get fired from Star and Buc?
Because that was a heavy pour.
Okay, I got my eye on you. That's a Dominican pour. Go ahead.
So Star and Buc were writing for Source, I think.
Okay, yeah, I remember.
Wait,
it was some
magazine. Pages is one of them.
Some magazine, they were writers.
I think it was a Source. It was a Source. Yeah, it was a Source. Yeah.
And then they submitted their stuff to Tracy, who was the program director at the time.
Okay.
Just to see, you know, if she might be interested in that type of material.
Tracy Clarity, right?
Tracy Clarity. Uh-huh. She was the boss.
Yes.
And so Ed Lover and Dr. Dre, the biggest probably morning show, well, until Star and Buc came, but at that time they were the biggest. They had just left.
Right.
And they were constantly, Hot 97 was trying to find a replacement.
Right.
And there were a lot of shows in between. So before Star and Buc Wild came,
I think they went to LA or some shit and they got like a $2 million.
Yeah, but then it didn't last.
Okay.
Unfortunately.
So then you get on Star and Buc Wild.
So I was on.
This is before you and Fat Man School?
No.
Okay.
It was me and Fat Man School.
First.
Right.
Okay, all right.
And
cool.
Then Tracy said in one of our meetings, I have this group of writers, this team of writers, and they want to write for your thing.
That's how they came in as writers?
I knew the play.
Oh, okay.
Because I'm from Queens.
Well, I didn't know that. I still don't know the play. Like, put me on.
Yeah, I knew the play. Like, yeah, sure, you want to be a writer.
Right.
You want to get in here. Mm. But I have no power. Like, I'm just happy to have a job. So they're writing for us. The material that he wrote probably was great material for him.
Right.
But it didn't work for me and Fat Man School. You know, put your hands up. We're happy. Yeah. We're like,
wait,
wake
who's
up.
Him? Who's him specifically?
Fat Man,
Star and Buc Wild.
Star.
No, there's two people.
Well, it was really Star.
It's really
Buc
Star.
Wild was just really like a slip star.
Yeah.
Without a microphone.
Okay.
I'm gonna throw my shoe at you.
Well, I killed that. I killed. If you know the real analogy, I just killed that.
Real quick, you did that. Star was writing material for Fat Man Scoop and I. That was not on brand.
Right.
That's what I'll call it. Not on brand.
Okay.
But he was still, you know, he was developing his relationship with Tracy all the while.
Right.
Me and Scoop are just trying to find our way and maintain something, but we kind of sensed that they weren't investing in us because they never made the title of the show Fat Man Scoop and Miss Jones or Miss Jones and Fat Man Scoop. It was a Hot 97 morning show.
Morning show,
These are things that people need to pay attention to when they're working and they're trying to make... Pay attention to labeling brands.
Like, if you could pay attention, like Joe Budden, he started his podcast. It was named his podcast later. And now his podcast is called the Joe Budden Podcast. You could have seen he was going solo.
You see the play.
He was going solo. I'm so
he
sorry,
named it
Joe.
Later.
Yeah, he named it later. He did name it later.
After all the views and the acclaim that he names it. But so we knew they weren't invested in us.
Uh-huh.
So one day, Tracy calls me in her office after the show went off, me and Fat Man Scoop.
Right.
And she's like, close my door. All right, so we're making a change.
Uh-huh.
Star and Buc Wild are going to be taking over the morning show, and I want you to be there with them.
Wow.
And I'm like, what about Scoop? She goes, Scoop's going to either overnight or middays, but he doesn't know, and if you tell him, you're fired.
Oh.
And she's like, you have to think about yourself, Jonesy.
Right.
Which, in hindsight now, being grown and right. being stung right. and trying to play good and still getting fucked over, right. she was right. right. I did need to look out for myself and not tell Scoop to play.
So let me just stop you right there. Did you tell Scoop to play?
I did not tell Scoop
to
play.
Oh, you did? Okay. All right.
Scoop, I'm sorry.
Well, he's just finding out now.
I mean,
okay.
it never came up.
Okay.
But to the point, Scoop knew my story and that as soon as I came home from college, my mom died like 2 weeks later.
Oh, God.
My dad died freshman year. So I had nothing. I was literally in those streets all them years that y'all heard me singing on mixtapes and doing radio, filling in, fighting for my life. Right. So I think Scoop understood, you know, I didn't have a backup plan. Right. I had to do what I had to do, really, or I could have been in them streets for real, or a drug dealer's girlfriend.
Right.
Sometimes I wonder, might not have been such a bad thing to be.
Oh, God. Hold on. let me drink some more.
So I didn't tell Scoop. Next week, it's like this whole big takeover of publicity. Star and Buc Wild.
Okay, let me ask you something, though. Was Star and Buc Wild at other stations prior to that?
No.
No, they wasn't. This is their first gig.
It's their first gig.
It was writers prior to that.
And they took over the morning show.
They did.
With the help of the Hot 97 engine.
But what was, it had to be one episode that stood out. What was the episode that stood out that made them say, let's give them the job?
No, there was no episode.
There was no episode.
They just built that relationship.
I think she built a, right. You know how, if I get into you and you feel me as a person,
right.
and you know I'm talented,
right.
the rest is just a matter of signing paperwork.
Right.
We'll figure the rest of the shit out.
Mm.
Right.
And why not give a chance? You know what
right.
I mean?
Right.
And I think Tracy wanted to take, Hot 97 had maybe climaxed. Right. She knew she needed to do something different to get the white boy listeners. No disrespect, love our white boys, but she wanted to hit Z100 people.
Right.
Because Hot 97, even though it was a pop station or Cherubin, as they used to call it, was really hip hop in the hood.
Mm-hmm.
The only way to be taken seriously and crack through was to get some of those
Go ahead.
Z100 listeners. And that is what Star and Buc Wild were able to do. And I say Star and Buc Wild. Now, I was featuring Miss Jones. I did my little straight man stuff, but it was his content and his perspective on the content. His spin on it.
So let me ask you, you said you didn't have anything to do with the Aaliyah thing, but what? How was that atmosphere like?
What was the Aaliyah thing? Describe it for anybody who doesn't know.
Jay-Z says a part of it in his rhyme. He says, stars, mags, I won't grab him an interview, but he dissed you. So I dissed something, so into you remix with Aaliyah. And what happened was Star and Buc Wild, Aaliyah did a car crash.
She died in a plane crash. And you know, that rocked. None of us had ever died. Like, that was like the first.
Yeah, that was really the first
of our
one.
Peers. You know what I mean? It was tragic and it was sudden.
Right.
And I need another shot.
Yeah, let's do another shot. But basically, Star and Buc did a skit.
It was more. The writer in the room.
Meant to be comedy, I'm assuming.
The writer in the room.
This is the definition of too soon. You know how when people say too soon?
This
is how the definition got invented. Was everyone was like, you know, we get it. Even comedians was like,
but
we
even
get
comedy
it.
Back then didn't believe in too soon.
Thank you.
Comedy doesn't believe in too soon still to this day. They'll make a joke about another comedian while he's going through it. Like, you know, Kevin Hart is a great example of that. He was going through it with his wife, and a lot of the comedians still gave it to him. You know,
and you have to, because you have to stay true to what it is.
Salute. So I think that was the meaning of too soon.
I mean, and so they were. I kept seeing them run in and out of the studio.
Sorry. We watching you. Just drink chance, bro. go ahead.
There was a lot of going in and out of the studio that morning. And I knew they were up to something.
Right. Rumor has it, Dame Dash called up.
That was later.
Okay.
That was later.
Okay.
This morning, when the song was about to be played, there was a lot of in and out of the studio. Star didn't go out the studio that much like that.
It was he stayed in?
He used to always stay there, and Reese, who was one of our writers at the time, he would come in with whatever he had. This morning, there was a, the both of them. So I knew something was coming, but I didn't know, but I'm not stupid, so I figured what it would be.
You don't even understand what they're about to play.
I had no idea.
Oh, this is crazy.
I didn't know this.
And how soon was it, though?
This was the next day, I think.
She passed Sunday.
This was Monday.
Oh, hell.
This was Monday, something like that. Like, she passed Saturday.
It wasn't a long time. Saturday.
And this was Monday.
They're going in and out, and I'm knowing, I'm sensing, and then I hear a little bit of, and I'm like, don't do it. I told Star, don't do it. This is why he says, Miss Jones knew. Right. I knew you was up to something involving that, but I didn't know the lengths that you was going to go, nigga, because you would have known I can't be a part of that.
Right.
Even if I wanted to ride with you, I can't. I can't do it.
Right.
So the next, it was like, we're halfway through the show, maybe close to the end.
Right.
They play the sound effects of a car crashing and a female voice screaming. Like, as if it's a shrill. It's like a shrill of someone perishing by fire. Like, do you want, like...
Yeah, that's what I thought, too. But
and the no, that's the plane. But then, did you hear the... the voice? It was like
I didn't even remember. Okay.
And right. And so you're thinking real quick in the moment, right, and the mics are on.
Right.
What do I do? What do I... There's not, like, so... I said... I separated myself from the situation. Right. I did. And... So I didn't appreciate it.
Okay.
And the phones got turned out.
Right.
And I walked off the show.
Right.
And Tracy came in. I don't think she knew quite the impact of what was going to happen or what was happening. But within 30 minutes, I think like 75% of the Hot 97 advertisers had called
And pulled out.
And pulled out. And she's on one phone and Judy is on another phone and they're trying to stop the bleeding.
Wow.
And so Tracy called me in her office at some point and like broke me down and was like, I don't care what happens. You don't leave your co-host and you don't walk off the show.
Wow.
What's this for? I'm crying.
No,
lipstick somewhere?
No, just in case.
Mr. Lee obviously thinks you need it.
Thank you for anticipating. So it was like mixed emotions because first she was telling me, you're fucked up basically. Not those exact words, for leaving Star. And letting him take all the heat.
Okay.
But I'm like, bitch, I didn't even think that up. Right. That wasn't one of my skits.
Right.
But I got it. And so again, here's Jonesy going against the grain of Hot 97.
Right.
3 hours later, after I'm home, she calls and goes,
great move.
I'm suspending Star. The people want you. I need you to fill in and like help clean this up, make this go away.
Let me ask you
That's something. Another example of...
Let me ask you now. When you come in that day, when you fill in, do you apologize on his behalf?
I did not.
Oh, wow.
They did not want me to read...
To even talk about it.
Right. Okay. Which is the stupidest thing.
It's on everyone's mind.
Everybody's waiting. And
that's like when
the person gets to the moon, they want
to
see what the hell your first words is.
Exactly. Right.
So like, okay.
But we're trained puppies that whenever a catastrophe happens, tsunami, you're told to not talk...
Then the tsunami.
Listen now, listen.
Was a tsunami after that?
Yeah, tsunami was after
that. And let me big up DJ Envy, because DJ Envy had to let the people know that Jonesy was not in the building. It was not in the building. But this is two controversial situations.
There's
though.
A lot. Listen, Nori. And there's some shit that you don't even know that I'm going to tell.
I'm ready. Let's go.
Organic
Food Kings in the building. God damn it. Let's do it.
And so at that point, I come in and I start doing the show and I'm trying to, just do the show and I can't talk about anything because they're trying to work out getting the advertisers back and stuff. Two airplanes decide to fly into the Twin Towers.
Wow.
Now, the pressure is intense. Hot 97 don't know what to do about Star. They don't know where the direction that they need to take to stop the bleeding and make this go away.
Right.
The two planes took that shit away.
They brung them back on.
Because when 9/11 happened,
they needed to laugh.
Sorry, Aaliyah. This is the leading story.
Wow.
Right. Yeah, it's like it erased everything. It's like start over.
So be it not for, I don't even know, like be it not for 9/11.
Wow.
There might have been a different outcome.
Right. Now the tsunami song Stardom had nothing to do with that?
Oh, no, that was all, it's not me, but it was my on my watch.
Okay.
Yeah, that was years later. So here's the thing.
Yeah.
9/11 happened. Yeah. Everybody, the America shifts gears. Yeah. The focus is no longer
America's
on.
America's no longer racist.
Right, exactly. Yeah. They're no longer racist.
Not towards our people. They, right. We are now the heroes.
Yeah, yeah. Although they've forgotten about this gorgeous, smart, intelligent black girl that died in a plane crash. Right. That just got tossed away.
Right.
Now we're all one.
Right.
Come out and help, you know. And so, you know, when that happened, Star got an opportunity to be responsible and do the right thing. He got like a second chance.
But here's what's funny about that, because didn't Jay-Z drop an album on 9/11 as well?
Did he? Yeah, on that day.
What album was it?
Blueprint on that day of 9/11. So you would think it would like even it
like
out.
Offset?
Yeah, offset it to a little. I'm asking. I'm just a, you know.
I wasn't even aware.
I don't think anything's going to offset 9/11.
No, I'm talking about offset, you know, like the, you know, the balance of Aaliyah's disrespect, because once again, it was disrespectful to a dead person.
Right.
Like a dead.
But that album had to already be in the, back then.
Okay, yeah, you're right, you're right.
You know,
you're
you
right.
have your set it, date.
Yeah, two years. Almost a year and a half.
Before the album drops. Half, yeah. Right.
It's a setup. Yeah,
you couldn't go back in and change the line back
then.
Right, because
Polygram or Polydor or whoever it is that's printing it. Right. So that was, that honestly was just probably the stars lining up.
So let me ask you, it's good bouncing around. Yeah. Did Jay and Dame ever take that personal with you, with the Aaliyah?
No.
Never?
I mean, so they were my, after that, they were my champions. They're like, Dame showed up to my birthday party at Caroline's.
Oh, because you walked out, that's right, okay.
Yeah, I was on the good side.
Okay.
And they've always, they put me in their movies, Death of a Dynasty, Paper Soldiers.
That's right, I'm in those too.
Thank you, Star.
Kevin Hart.
Yeah, I worked with Kevin Hart before Kevin Hart was like really, really.
Yeah. Right.
So, you know, and so I didn't, sometimes shit be happening so fast, you don't know the right thing to do.
Right.
And I just did what I knew I couldn't be a part of. I knew what that outcome would look like if I had stayed in that chair.
Right.
So I bounced.
Right.
I abandoned things. I have abandonment issues.
Right.
So I leave when I don't know.
Lee, where you at? Let's give her another shot, because we want to talk about when Wendy Williams tried to kill you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Y'all gotta finish this tsunami. You keep telling tsunami.
Oh,
I know the fuck y'all talking about.
Right, you're right.
Hey, can
you're
I
right.
say something? Uh-huh. I have some friends from, you know, Queens Flip.
Yes.
That I work with that came down here. That I want to shout out.
Yeah,
came
absolutely.
Down here.
Okay, yeah, no problem.
Yeah,
Queens Flip.
Do it now.
Do now.
Come on through. This is DJ G Money.
Okay.
He does the Queens Flip, like, Envy put me on his back to bring me back.
Right.
I know, G Money, what's up? You've been over here this whole time. Come over here, say what's up. Give us a five. And we're going to bring you in at the end, but we're going to give us a five. No, come on. Come on, bro. Yeah, man, we're proud of y'all.
Take the eaters.
We're proud of y'all. You're proud of y'all.
Flip the script. Hey, babe.
Appreciate you.
We're proud of y'all.
Thank you for coming all the way down here.
What's good, man?
This is family. Yeah. I just have to show support for the family.
Hell yeah. We're gonna bring you in that day. Hold on. Yeah. That's nice. I like this. What were we talking about? The tsunami. We finished up the tsunami.
Yeah, I want to know what y'all talking about.
Yeah, so
I heard something about this.
That's when you go, and then we're gonna talk about when Wendy Williams tried to get a kill.
We'll get back to the murder.
Okay, we'll put the murder on back burner for now. Okay.
So this is another parody song situation.
Yes.
What's with morning shows and parody songs?
It's a big deal. And white and radio.
Yeah, I'm talking, they've been doing that.
Right. So remember now, we're trying to get that Z100.
So that's what it is, trying to compete with that and get that audience?
So she hired.
They still do these songs parodies to these days, if you look at
it. Right, but I mean, we're talking about like stuff that's like.
You know, everyone is politically correct right now. Everybody don't want to defend nobody.
Right now. It's going to flip in a minute. You know that, right?
Yeah.
And it's going to go back to ratchet, fuck your mother, fuck your father, fuck your kids. It's going back.
So the tsunami. What happens is, let's just describe to people. This was like the world's worst tsunami that we pictured.
Mad people died.
So this song comes out, and what is the song? Do you remember how the song
went? I do.
Okay.
At this point, so Star had fired me. Mm. I'm in Philly. I'm doing great in Philly. Big shout out to Philly, help me.
Well, you
down.
Said Star fired you now.
Star fired
me. I thought
me.
It was Hot 87. No.
No, it was Star.
Okay, all right.
So, after.
Yeah, but what did you do that? You
all right, hold on. Let's see. Yeah, what did you do? Yeah, okay.
No, it was the Aaliyah
thing. Oh, the Aaliyah thing. Okay, I remember. Okay,
it was.
Okay.
So after that, he rebounded. Ratings went back up after 9/11.
How much time is this now?
I don't know. What year did the Aaliyah. It was close enough that you knew. He was still salty about me abandoning him on the show.
Right. So he knew when he came back, he was gonna fire you eventually.
Probably.
Right. Okay.
And then when he fired me, before he fired me, Tracy had already come to me with a new contract. Right. We had already agreed to an amount. I was good.
But a contract under that show?
Yeah, under that show. Okay, no, cool. Under that show.
Cool, cool.
And she knew I had just bought a new apartment. I had just gotten, not bought, a new apartment.
On the west side?
On 116th and Lennox. That apartment building called, I think it's a Renaissance. No, uh-huh. Whatever it is, it's on the corner of Lennox and 116th. Uh-huh. I had just gotten it, and I was so excited. Uh-huh. She knew this ain't the time to be firing the nigga.
Right.
But Star, I renegotiated. And maybe part of the new terms were that he got to decide who would be on his show. Because right. Going in, she put me on the show because she knew Star and Buc Wild needed someone familiar that had been there.
Right.
Someone that could actually read and articulate and has a relationship with artists, knows the background of the artist. Yeah. Star and Buc Wild were anti-artists, for those of you that don't know.
Yeah.
They didn't know, they might have known a lot, but the artists didn't necessarily fuck with them.
Right.
The good thing about Jonesy is that everybody loves Jonesy.
Right. Goddamn, make some noise for that. continue.
So I was there. I served a purpose. After that Aaliyah thing, my purpose didn't much matter. Because he rebounded and they renegotiated with him. And then she said, Star doesn't want you in the show anymore. I said, you're my boss. I'm not working for Star. She's like, yeah, well, but meet with him, talk to him, you know. Just make him think, do whatever you have to do, is what she said. Do whatever you have to do to remain a part of that show.
Right.
I was in Atlantic City the next weekend. I came home early. Me and my girlfriend, Cherise, from Changing Faces. Do you mind if I stroke you up? So we're in Atlantic City. I'm like, bitch, we got to go home because I got to kiss up the Star. I pulled up to his building. He comes out. He's like, yeah, it's not me. It's the other guys on the show. They don't think that you're loyal. They don't want you around. Yeah. So basically, he doesn't give me my job back. Wow. And I'm like jobless with this new apartment in Harlem. Right, and I don't know what I'm going to do.
Right.
Wendy gets word. Everyone got word that Star was going to fire me before I did.
Right.
Wendy calls. Now, at that point, Kevin, her husband, or her ex-husband now, was calling shots. He did not want me and Wendy to remain friends because he always thought I was a threat.
Right.
So she's whispering on the phone. Jones, I know you just got let go, and I know you need a job. Call this person and that person in Philly. Tell them that Wendy told you to call.
Wow.
And I wound
that's
up.
That's dope.
Yeah. So that's why I say, despite them trying to have me murdered, I can't be but so mad.
Wait, but murder is
So
that's before Tsunami.
Now let's get to the Tsunami and I'm gonna get back to the murder.
Yeah.
Okay.
To the murder?
That's a lot of shit. Wait, can we get up for a lot of shit?
You don't know a lot of shit, goddamn.
You
ain't
a murder? Murder? So, all right.
Because the Tsunami song was like
murder, murder.
The Tsunami song was like what is a lot of people are experiencing right now. There's an Asian hate bill that went around.
And so So it's kind of out of order. So Wendy did that. I went to Philly. I'm in Philly rocking. Star is calling my phone, harassing me on my voicemail. Yeah, you think you're doing something down in Philly, but I'm about to come for you. They're about to have me syndicated in Philly, and I'm going to take you down. He's on my voicemail saying these things.
Oh, yeah. That's how people was back in the day. That's how you threatened a person.
And it's like, all right, whatever.
You basically sending yourself to jail.
Yeah.
back in the day. That was DMs back then.
Right, those were DMs back then.
Yeah.
So eventually, I do wind up coming back to New York. And when I come back to New York, Tracy, again, she's hired. Do you remember Opie and Anthony?
Yeah.
She hired their producer, Rick Delgado. So, if you know Opie and Anthony, you know that Star and Buc Wild ain't got shit on the antics that those two motherfuckers did.
Right.
They had, for example, a couple having sex, and I think it was
cathedral.
Yeah, one of the cathedrals.
Yeah.
I don't even know the name of the cathedrals,
Yeah, it's fucked up.
Right.
Yeah.
It's so bad. And so she hired so bad.
Right.
And so he was now my come back to New York. Miss Jones is coming back. Right. I've never met this man. She hired him to be my producer.
Right.
Now, I am 9 months pregnant with Jalen. Big shout out to Jalen, my son.
Oh, big up. Hey. What's up? Hey. What's going on? Okay. That's what's up.
And I'm pregnant, and so I'm grateful to have a job.
Right.
And so I'm home because I had just had him in December. Tsunami happened. We call it Tsunami, sorry. Me, Envy, and those of... In like January, February, I was home nursing him.
Right.
But what Hot 97 did to accommodate me at that time, because they wanted me really bad to come back, because now Star's across the street at Power 105.
And what's it called, the Miss Jones Show or the Miss Jones Experience?
It was called Miss Jones in the Morning.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah. So when I told them that I needed, I'll do your show, but I can't be coming all the way, like, come on.
Right.
Like,
Right.
They set up what was now Zoom
right.
10 years ahead of time.
Wow.
They pay like $10,000 a month.
Wow.
For me to have a TV at home,
wow,
where I could nurse Jalen and I could see DJ Envy, Miss wow. Info.
That's big.
This is wow. before the technology was even like accessible to people.
Wow.
And so Rick Delgado came up with this Tsunami Song thing. And so he's like, through the TV, he's telling me, I came up with this idea, I'm gonna play it, whatever, whatever. He plays it. And this is sad to say how asleep at the wheel people be.
Right.
But he played it in the 6 o'clock hour. 6 o'clock niggas don't really give a fuck. Because they're either getting off work or still sleepy and getting to work.
Or they're at happy hour.
Let me give it up for happy hour.
Yeah, give it up for happy hour.
Yeah. And so Dr. Jeff, who you know from Love and Hip Hop, he was on my show first.
Yeah.
He came in at 8 o'clock. He came in at 8 o'clock every whatever morning that was. And we're talking about the Tsunami Song because Miss Info was like, she was like, y'all shouldn't have done that. I'm telling y'all, she really was the adult in the room.
Wow.
And so we're like, all right, but whatever. And I'm not there. I'm seeing through a TV and I'm like, the show got to keep going. They did it, but we got to keep going. Dr. Jeff comes in and goes, what are y'all talking about? Can I hear the song? We play the song in the 8 o'clock hour, which we find out later on is the most listened to hour.
Wait, so him asking, what are you talking about? Let me hear it. Is this on the air?
Oh, yeah.
Right.
So Rick plays that motherfucker.
Right.
And when I tell you, they come, the salespeople come running. I'm watching through the TV and I'm like, what's going on? Right. And I'm home, but I'm still present.
Is it similar to the Leah situation or is it just, okay, all right.
But it's like, right. I know it's going down. Like, it was different because I couldn't be there physically to manage it. I'm home now, I'm a mom,
right.
I'm soft and pink, I'm right. not with the shits. But I got with it real quick because the boss then was Barry Mayo. Tracy is now gone. Barry right. Mayo brought me back.
Okay.
He drives from New York
right.
all the way to Willenboro. Big right. shout out to right. your partner Capone.
Okay, yeah, exactly.
Because we used to hang out in Willenboro. Thrill Capone.
Yes.
And he says, we got a problem.
Okay.
So I'm like, what's going on? He's like, the world is mad and they want your head on a platter.
Wow.
And I'm like, why my head? Well, you played the song. Bitch, I'm here. How am I playing the song? So what the play was, I believe he was in trouble because now he is corporate.
Right.
Who approved that?
He's the PD?
He's the GM.
Okay.
That's over the PD.
Oh, okay.
Right. And earlier that morning, it came out later on, big shout out to DJ Envy and Research.
Right.
That he came into the studio after it was played and was like, y'all are sick motherfuckers, but that was funny as hell. Allegedly.
Wow.
But Tsunami didn't go away. Ugh. It didn't go over well, and it did not go away. And so
now,
everyone,
was this the Asian community at first? Or this was just anybody who was just
at first it was everybody.
Tsunami.
I can see everybody being.
Everybody was upset. It was too sensitive. It was wildly offensive. It was distasteful. It was shameful. And it was just not where we needed to be. There was no need. Like,
right.
There's other shit we could have found that was funny.
Right.
But again, you dealing with Opie and Anthony's producer, this is what they do.
Wow. You said Opium Anthony?
Opie and Anthony's producer, Rick Delgado.
Wait, remember, Opium?
Opie, right?
I dream.
Opie, oh,
look,
I thought it was Opium.
I dream,
I
dream.
All right.
Opie and Anthony's producer, Rick Delgado. Okay. This is right up the lane of the shit that they did. Mm-hmm. So he knew he was hired to get with the shits.
Right.
So now everyone's blaming me because now the phones are ringing. 99% of the McDonald's said bye.
Right.
And now I'm going to Power. See, before, they didn't have another station to go to. When Aaliyah happened, Power wasn't, it wasn't even invented, what's the word?
Created.
Right, it wasn't created then. So it's like, all right, take your money, but bitch, where you gonna put it?
Right.
Right.
Now, there's another street And right. guess what? They're open. Right. They're willing to give you bargains.
Nothing competing with you.
Right. And they just ate that shit up. And stars on the radio going, oh, those tsunami insensitive bastards down the block, bring your money here. Wow. Your money's good with us. We'll never insult your community. Oh.
Even though he was not a part of the Tsunami Song.
No, he was at Power then.
Oh, yes, right. You're right.
So he's highlighting it. He's like, remember? Yeah. Remember what they said about you guys? Like, he's just twisting it. And so now corporate at Hot 97 has to make a decision. Now, I'm newly back. I just came back like 3 months prior. And so they sent the lawyer. This is what happens, boys and girls, right. when you've gone too far at your job. They got the white boys, the lawyers, they came in overnight and they met secretly with everybody on my show individually by themselves to get the story of what the fuck happened.
Wow.
So me, Miss Info's pissed off, like no one's talking to her because we're like, oh, fuck you. You probably the one that told the agents to come and boycott us. Envy and research. Her name is Tay, but she was like, I call her research because she was like our full research department. Are being interviewed, and the story was that Miss Jones sung on the song, and because it's her show, she's responsible for this.
Right.
So when the lawyers spoke to Envy and research, they said so. They're asking the questions and they're like, yeah, Rick did the song. And they're like, well, who's singing on the song? Because it says Rashawn, this DJ Envy, Tasha, and we know that's Miss Jones.
Wait, DJ Envy sung on the Tsunami Song?
Rick made him do it.
Oh, wow, Envy, we didn't know this.
All right, but maybe he didn't.
We didn't know Rashawn.
Maybe, maybe he didn't know he sang on it?
Yeah, Envy died, my bad, bro.
But there were voices from that show on that song. Yeah. So when he said, and Miss Jones, you know, she was singing too. Envy was like, Envy and research were like, Miss Jones, she hasn't been here since November. And they're like, wait a minute, what? How has she not? We hear her every day. So Envy's like, we have the system where she logs on in the morning and she pops up on a TV screen.
And it wasn't and that's for that, they would have fired you.
They would have fucking fired the pregnant big up
DJ.
Woman.
Let's big up DJ Envy.
He holds you down.
And research, she did too. Because she confirmed it. So the lawyers are now like, this ain't what Barry Mayo told us, allegedly. So I'm thinking, and the people that love me are thinking, that Barry Mayo, who was the GM, was trying to sacrifice me for his letting that whole thing happen. And once I'm fired, he's saved. No one asked questions.
He's a scapegoat of that situation.
And then you know they don't let you talk about shit again on radio.
It's gag order, right?
Right. Uh-huh. So I knew that what was about to happen. And, well, Jalen's dad at the time told me he saw the play. My sister is a real big producer in daytime television. She has, like, five Emmy Awards and, like, 500 nominations. She produces The View. Before that, she produced Nancy Grace and Johnny Cochran. She saw my name on the news because America knew about the Tsunami Song. It was bigger than New York. It was bigger than Nino Brown. It was international news. And everybody hated Miss Jones because that's what they were being given as responsible for the Tsunami Song.
And they did blame you for Aaliyah's thing, too?
They didn't blame me for that. Okay, no. Just Tsunami.
All right.
My sister called Nancy Grace because she's like, I know TV. I know how narratives are painted if there's no one countering that. Right. And Hot 97 is not defending my sister. Nancy Grace said, tell her to call Mel Sachs. He's the best attorney. I hope she has money, but he's the only one that can fix her. At that time, Lil' Kim was in a little trouble, and her attorney was Mel Sachs. I called Mel Sachs. He had already known. He's deceased since then. He's like, come to my office. I need 50 grand, and we'll fix this. We get the 50 grand. We go to his office. Kim's coming out of the elevator. I'm going in. And he goes, oh, Miss Jones and Miss Jones, because her real name is Kimberly Jones. I tell him what happened. He's like, I already know. I'm going to, I can fix this. And I just need your money. And he said, you know what's going to happen. First of all, no one's going to want to be on the hook for firing a black pregnant woman. But when they find out that you weren't even on the song. So we had to tell them that the Tasha that was on the song singing wasn't me. researched his first name, Miss Tasha.
Oh.
I'm Tarsha. She's Tasha. She was the one that was singing, but she was singing it because Rick Delgado told her. Rick hadn't stepped up. Rick could have put all this shit in a smash.
Said, I did this as me,
right,
as my
but
idea.
But that nigga was trying to keep his job, and I get it. But we all went through hell, so I think at that point, me...
And Rick is a white man?
He's a white man. Okay. Me, Envy, and Tay, and because she's on my reunion show, we bonded based on niggas was about to, like, cancel us for real, for real. Right. And the Asians, they don't stop. Like, when they're passionate and they feel like you fucked them around, they don't stop. They don't stop. They don't stop. They don't stop. So the lawyers, my lawyer, Mel, talked to John Liu, who was then, like, the Asian community's person. He's the one that gears them up and told him she's not the one. Hot 97 realizes that she's not the one and they're willing to bring her back.
Right.
But we know once they bring her back, you are going to have your people boycott, and at that point, they're gonna have to let her go.
Right.
John Liu said, I know it wasn't you. Alleged. All this shit is alleged, but it's true. I know it wasn't you. I appreciate you even meeting with me. And if you go back to work, you don't have to worry.
Right.
You don't have to worry. We ain't going. So I went back. It was a Thursday. It was a very, or a Friday. It was a very calculated move to have me come back on a Friday. For those of you that don't know, Friday news cycle gets tossed in the garbage. Because who reads a newspaper Friday on Saturday?
Right.
So if something happens on Friday, you on your way to the strip club or the car wash at least,
right,
getting a haircut. You ain't reading the paper.
Right.
So I got on air Friday. I apologized in the early hour because, you know, niggas ain't listening at 6 o'clock hour.
For the tsunami thing?
For the tsunami thing.
Uh-huh.
And then when people started tuning in and hearing me back, of course, we got some phone calls. Oh, but the Asians didn't do their thing. And I was able to live to see another day.
And you were this info got into it because of that?
We did, because I felt like, I felt, which is so hypocritical of me.
This you
is
did the really same thing.
I did the same shit with Star. Who the fuck am I?
So you got mad at her.
I did.
You're foul.
I was feeling myself. I'm so bitchy. Yeah. That was so bad. Miss Info, I'm sorry. I apologize.
Oh, that's so good.
Yeah. I was very, I was out of
pocket.
So
you know, this is a part of our show. It's called Quick Time with Slime. We're just gonna ask you a quick question.
Okay.
And you go pick one or the other, but if you pick both, you gotta take a shot. it's okay. It's okay. Are you ready?
What's the loss?
All right.
There's no losing.
There's no losing.
Okay. I don't know where you can go with this one. I think I know you can go with this one. Nas or Jay-Z?
Nas.
Okay, that was dope. Don't know this one.
She was quicker than quick time.
I don't know this one. Cardi or Nicki?
Cardi.
Oh. I wasn't really. I know you're going to go with this one. Mary J or Toni Braxton?
Who?
Or Toni Braxton. Mary J or Toni Braxton?
Mary.
Mary Mature. Mary Mature. All right. 90s hip hop or 2000 hip hop?
90s.
Damn, you're pretty, this was okay.
Yeah, 90s.
All right. Drink Champs or Joe Budden podcast?
Drink Champs. Queens get the money.
In Miami.
All right.
In Miami. I am Miami.
All right. I can't lie. This one, Funk Flex or DJ Clue?
Shots. Okay, so here's the thing. There's a lot of shit in the play right now.
All right.
With my career. And Flex is very powerful. But Clue is like Envy's boy, and Envy kind of, bold.
Let's go to shot. I was with that. Take the shot. Where's her bottle, Lee? Get her bottle. Oh, shit. Oh, yeah, I'm in.
And that's not a bad both.
No, that's not.
They both stood the time.
Yeah.
Thank you. Right, they're different, Lee,
don't,
but we
don't
love them
heavy,
both.
Don't have you pour,
just
bro.
So you know, I would have went both.
Yeah.
I would have.
Come on, N.O.R.E, you
salud,
already know.
Salud. I love them both. Cheers. I love them both. All right, hold on. Where we at? All right, this one I think is fairly easy. Podcast or radio?
Podcast.
Oh, fuck.
All right. Wait, you thought I was going to say radio?
Yeah, definitely did.
So here's the thing. Radio gives a lot more money faster,
right,
but they bind you up like you're a runaway slave.
Right.
So you can't really own what you're doing on podcast.
You own it and you can be who you are.
Facts.
And how you want to do it.
And how you want to execute it.
Right.
Okay. I think you're taking a shot for these next couple of ones.
Uh-oh.
All right. DMX or Tupac?
DMX. DMX.
Oh, okay. Yeah. All right, I didn't expect that.
Yeah, you know
Foxy
why?
Foxy or Lil' Kim?
I don't think neither one of them fuck with me. So can I say neither?
You still gotta take a shot if you say neither. And then I don't want to get into that.
I feel it in you.
But by the way,
you got a Tupac story.
Hold on, give me another shot. But by the way, this is the first neither we've ever had.
Oh yeah, that's the first.
That's the first neither.
Really?
No, really. I'm taking an extra shot just because of neither. Because holy shit, I've never heard no one say neither.
Yeah,
that's
really?
The first neither. Word.
And I have reason. It's just not some random answer.
We gonna get into the reason.
I know you will.
This is a salute. Salute to neither. I've never heard neither. Yeah, it's quick time. It's live.
Fuck with me, so.
Okay. I think it's fairly easy, but I could be fooled. New York or Philly?
Ooh. Come poor.
I respect that, so
Because of course I'm a New Yorker to the core.
Yes.
I love the fact that I'm a Queens girl.
Yes.
There's just something special about
us
motherfuckers.
Yes,
I am so proud to be a Queens girl, but when New York let me, like you let me have a threesome. And I liked it.
Whoa.
Okay, salute. Let's take a shot.
Take a shot.
Philly gave me so much love. I'm like, what's her name on the shot?
Okay.
Yeah.
You ready? You got to get through.
Oh, cheating.
We watching you. All right. This one, I'm up in the air. Queen Latifah or MC Light?
Light.
I'm
a
rock.
There's a story.
Erykah Badu or Jill Scott?
Jilly from Philly.
I respect that. Eve or Missy? No.
Neither.
That's a shot, though, too. You do know. We already established neither.
You made new rules on this.
You made new rules on
this. I can't fuck with it.
I'm sorry, sis.
I got a drink because I can't fuck with either.
Wait, I need to get to the
Yo,
listen, I'm not going to lie. I need to get into the neither because we never had this.
I can't do it.
I respect that. Okay, all right.
Right, but I like where you're going with this.
Yes. All right, cool. There's only a couple left. There's only a couple left.
Up for the questions. Hold on.
Okay.
Oh.
Kanye or Pharrell?
Beautiful.
That's Pharrell?
Hey.
That's definitely Pharrell.
Yeah.
I'm definitely in the air with this one. Puff or Dre?
Puff. Because even though... You want to know why?
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely. Because
even though he jacked my whole shit and made me have to work a lot harder.
You unpacked that one.
Yeah. Even though I had to work a lot harder and reinvent myself in radio to become a success, at the end of that success, Diddy did a reality show with me.
Wow.
For free.
Wow.
And that look, even though the show didn't happen, that look created another look for me. So I feel like Diddy gave me reparation.
Oh, that's fire. That's fire. Let's make some money.
Any reason not Dre? Is there any specific reason not Dre?
Dre was never very, warm. Diddy's personality was always like, come on, Jonesy.
Right.
Come on, Jonesy. What is it? How much?
That's his personality still right now.
Right, he would call up and be like, really? Y'all fucking with me like that?
Yeah, he's very petty. He's very petty.
The petty is real.
I love it.
I'm here for the petty.
Yeah, I'm here for the petty. Yeah. Okay, all right. Hot 97 or Power? Take a shot?
Oh, Hot 97.
I respect your maturity. I swear to God. I thought you were going to still be petty Ventura, but no.
No. I'm petty white because.
You're petty white. But you know what? You're not petty.
I could be petty Betty and I could be all those things, but here's what you don't realize.
Okay, I want you to realize.
Power 105 is Clear Channel that fired me in Philly.
Mm.
So fuck you.
Oh, my bad.
Yeah, she gang-ganged on that one.
And I wasn't ready.
And then you fired me because allegedly I said some things about some woman's daycare that cost her business. And then we find out years later that she lied and went to prison and you never cleared my name. Mm. So I'm not fond of you. Because you never know. There might be an opportunity over there.
Mm. Right. All
but,
good.
Yeah, Hot 97.
All right, this is okay, this is the last one. Loyalty or respect?
Loyalty. Because respect can be premised by...
If someone's loyal to you, they're going to respect you.
It don't matter, right? It don't matter what it is. It's I'm down for what... I'm down for you because I'm down for you.
Right.
I'm not respecting you because you've done this or I respect you because you've not done that. Right. I'm loyal whether you're a shitbag or whether you're a rock star. Right.
That's respect. So now you're away.
No, hold up, hold up, hold up. She has a Tupac story.
Oh, you want to go there?
Really small. All
right.
Me and Moni Love.
Shout out Moni.
Love. I love Moni Love.
All I'm going to say is, look, me and Moni Love.
She had beef with Pac a little bit.
Not that night.
Okay. Oh, oh, okay. All right, then. She ain't tell me this one.
About to call Moni up right now.
Okay, Moni. Yeah.
Am I saying too much?
No,
do I need to ask her if it's all right to tell?
Okay, okay.
All right, I'm not going to tell a story.
All right, tell someone.
No, I can't.
She gave me some Tupac
stories. Let's call her then. And
let's call her then. Call her
live shows.
I'm her brother, just like I'm your brother. Let's go.
Let's see. I'm going to try to see if I get on the phone.
Just blame it on the drink champ.
I will.
Just blame it on.
You, and just so you know, niggas don't answer my calls when they know I'm... like with people. And he's like, I will never, because you're always having me on the mic. Mm. So you text me, I hear what it is, and then I call you back.
Okay, but let's get into the Tupac story. What happened that night?
It was just the, it was the Biggie Platinum Party. Remember Biggie had gone platinum?
This is legend. Wait up. Tupac was at Biggie's Platinum Party. Whoa! That's what you start out with?
Yeah,
whoa!
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Go ahead.
Everybody was there, and you were told, the invitation came to your record label, you were told, black tie. This is the first time that niggas was not allowed to have the baggy, the Carl Kanai. Mm. We had feathers, boas, sequins, and
this is like, niggas is like, wow, we going Hollywood.
Exactly.
This is black Hollywood.
That was black Hollywood.
This is social media being created.
Right, and you got niggas from the West Coast.
You created social media a little bit in my mind.
Yeah, I think I kind of did. Like, I'll take credit for a part of it, at least, because you would hear something on my
show.
You
was like the first Twitter, first Facebook.
Yeah.
You was like the first DM. Like, hitting you on the private line was the DM.
Right. By default. I didn't want to be that, but niggas had that one line number, like, Jonesy. You know, I didn't fuck that bitch.
Right.
Kick her out the studio.
Right.
But so Pac came, and it was kind of like, and me and Moni were friends at that time, so we went to the party together. And everybody was at that party. I'm sure you were at that party.
I was in jail at the time. I'm sorry.
Ooh, okay.
But I heard about the party.
Another party.
Hurt my feelings. It definitely hurt. I knew exactly what she was talking about. I just was in jail. I'm sorry. I came home later. It's okay.
I'm gonna tell you about the party. So Pac came, and we're in the crowd. We're walking, and it's like the music stops. Uh-huh. Everyone else hears the music, but I'm with Moni, and he stops, and he looks at us, and then so like we know what the look means, and we figure it out, and it was a good night. And that was it. Jalen, I'm sorry.
Don't worry about me. I feel like he's used to this.
I forget that he's in here. So
Pac and Moni had some relations.
Oh, no. It was just petty. Just the three of us.
Moni,
just the three of us
she
just talked for a long time.
Just the three of y'all.
Just the three of us just talked for a long time.
Holy moly, guacamole.
Yeah, man. I'm sorry, bro. I'm sorry, son.
Now I catch what's going on.
They was reading books, man.
No, I'm not.
Read books? Nacho Libre. That's a beautiful thing.
Yeah. With a bow on top.
That's a beautiful thing. One time. Okay, that's a beautiful thing. Okay, let's move on. So Wendy Williams tried to murder you. Where was you at when you got the news? You sitting around, you getting two ways, because I imagine...
You get the news on the murder?
You got the news, right?
Because at that time,
like it was
it's
a hit
not...
On you?
No. Yeah. So I'm in Aruba.
Okay, let's just be clear. Is this after Pac and Big died?
Yes. This is in 2008.
I know we're talking about it like it's in such a slight situation right now, right? But let's just be clear. After Pac a big dive. This is a very serious thing.
It is.
To even have this implication. Right. Right? So I'm just asking you.
Because niggas are following through on threats.
I mean, pocket biggest examples of that, this threats is being...
Correct.
Delivered.
Right.
So you're away, and you thinking it's a joke? Or what is your first thoughts when they say, yo, turn on the TV, sis, because I think someone called you, and they say, yo,
Charisse from Change of Faces.
Okay.
My bestie.
All right. What's the
ringing.
Song again?
You always do you mind if I stroke you?
So Charisse called you, go ahead.
She calls, and I'm like, who's calling? Because everyone...
You mind if I...
We got to break out R. Kelly, too, by the way. But anyway... So, wait, what?
We'll go back to that. Right.
Is that a long conversation too with somebody else?
It's all a long conversation. So the phone is ringing, but when people know you on vacation, they're not calling.
Right.
The phone keeps ringing and ringing and ringing. So I'm like, did somebody die? I pick up the phone. She goes, bitch, are you all right? And I'm like, what happened? That motherfucking Wendy, they trying to fucking put a hit out on you, bitch. So she goes, turn on the news. So I'm in Aruba with my new husband. And I see a split screen that reminds me of the tsunami. And it's my face, but now it's Wendy's face. And it says, rival DJ puts plots murder hit on competition.
Damn.
Who does? Like,
and she was just helping you.
Now, let me
two
just say something.
Ago.
Right.
Prior to Biggie and Pac's, you know.
Untimely death.
Untimely death.
Undoing, yeah.
I would have took it as a joke. After Biggie and Pac's death, I don't think this should be taken lightly. So, but tell me how you're taking it.
So I'm because I'm out of the country and I don't know.
Aruba,
the,
I didn't know. Goddamn, yeah, it, make some noise for our floors. Goddamn, Aruba, Aruba, goddamn, that's a beautiful ass place. Go ahead. But it's not the place you want to be threatened at. Like, you don't be threatened in Aruba.
You might go missing.
Yeah,
you don't want to be like killed.
Not in America. Right. You don't want to have drama in America when you're in Aruba.
It could go down in Aruba. You need to get the fuck out of Aruba.
That's what she's saying. You could go missing in Aruba.
You guys are bad.
She, like, she got some
y'all
drama
bad.
In,
y'all
in America.
Bad.
Okay, good.
You're facetious and sarcastic and it's going overheads.
No, we do. But go ahead, you in Aruba. That's
I'm in
the
Aruba
worst place to be threatened.
Because I can't get the pulse of if the right. shit is real or not.
Right.
And my husband, he's like, at the time, my husband,
right.
he's always laid back and cool. He's like, I'll take care of it when we get back. Don't worry, sweetheart. We good. So we get back, but the whole rest of the vacation, I'm like, is this real? Is this real? And come to find out, it's real. So Envy, once again, Envy to the rescue.
God damn it, Envy. Light-skinned dudes in karate class. We respect you, Envy.
In karate class?
In my mind, Envy always classes? Go to karate class. In my mind. That's my friend. That's my friend.
And why not?
I don't know. I just feel like he's going to karate class. It's okay. Him and Joe Biden together. Light-skinned people get together like this. That. I'm sorry.
No, it's okay.
Go ahead.
My memory serves me well. Envy called when I got back.
Wow.
Or we're on the show together, and he goes, by the way, after his little morning mix, by the way, Jones, Kevin said don't believe that bullshit.
Right.
Y'all good. No, you don't get to say don't believe that bullshit when Lisa Evers just did a full thing.
Who works at Hot 97,
who
by
works
the way.
At Hot, by
Street
the way.
Soldiers.
By the way.
Wow. Lisa Evers reported on it?
And said, I have a 30-page document that, it's, if you Google it, it still comes up.
Yeah, this is not funny. I know we laughed about it a little bit, but I don't think this is funny.
So did you get to the bottom of it?
Like,
no, I didn't. Because
so you never spoke to Wendy about it?
Because at that time, so this is when the downward spiral of the Miss Jones enterprise began. So my business relationship with Hot 97 is coming to an end, which is fine because I was only supposed to be there 3 or 4 years, but they asked me to stay an extra year because they needed to get Big Boy. He wound up taking over.
Yeah,
Big Boy from L.A.
Big Boy's my friend. I speak to him.
They syndicated him over there.
We hated New York radio right. at that time when we listened to Big Boy giving traffic about La Cienega. We did not like
La Cienega.
We did not like La Cienega, all that shit.
California
that
he, stuff.
Like California traffic. I'm sorry, and I speak to Big Boy. Look, I will literally show you the pages right now.
Yeah.
We're literally speaking right now, but when he took over and he was giving, it wasn't that he took over, he was giving us the same show that he was giving to California.
Right, you can't be mad at him, though. That's corporate shit. Doing
no, I'm mad at him because
he should have
knew better. Like, give New York their own show.
You gotta
show,
give
but,
New York. Yeah, like, right. Steve Harvey, yeah, nigga, yeah. You better start giving New York, New York, or I'm coming for that job.
Right. So, continue. Oh, this is so great.
So, they asked me to stay an extra year while they could get him all the way together. Mm. I don't have a problem. See, everybody thinks I got fired from Hot 97.
Ebo came with your podcast and said that's not true.
Right. Yes. I gave them an extra year because I was syndicated in Philly and New York didn't know. So when y'all was listening to me, when Wendy put the hit and all that stuff, I was already on Philly. They wanted me to come back. Right. So I'm like, I just go 95 South rather than go 95 North to New York.
But let me just stop you for a second. Is there any point where you just really thought that that was real though? Like, oh.
I feel like she thinks it's real.
I was going through so much internal turmoil within my marriage.
Right.
And the station in Philly that I was about to be driving 95 South to, that I couldn't even be present to it because I'm trying to secure my bag.
What does the article
bag.
Say? The article says rival radio station pulls out hit.
I'm like, that's white people shit. Like, do we even do that?
Right.
And so when Envy said, I saw Kevin in the club this weekend, and he said, don't worry about it. It's all good. They're not trying to kill you. I'm like,
Kevin is Wendy's.
Well, Kevin is Wendy's ex-husband.
Right,
okay.
Right.
I'm like, okay.
Like, don't worry about it. Like, we took the hit off.
Right. Like, they're not coming tonight.
Right.
So, and then my ex-husband was like, I got you. And he was somewhat in the street.
Right.
So when he said, I got you, I'm like, okay, he got me. They're going to figure whatever it was. But again, my life, I was transitioning out of New York radio. So I really didn't give a fuck all that much. And at the end of the day, ain't nobody coming that close to me, even without my husband,
right.
That's not going to get some pushback. Like, I'm not no fucking rollover.
No, but how
oh my
was
God.
It? Because at one point, I apologize.
No, it's fine.
But it was you, Angie, Steph Lover, and Wendy. All at the same station. Was that one time? Or I'm bugging. I think Steph wasn't there at the time with you, Angie,
no, you're
and
right.
Wendy.
No, you're right.
Or there was those four.
Yeah.
And arguably, what turns out to be, that's like the most powerful four women in radio.
Yeah. I actually have a t-shirt.
Huh.
Inspired by Redman's t-shirt that says, it goes Jonesy, Wendy, and Angie.
Wow.
That's it. No more names.
That got deep.
No more names. Jones. I might put Yee on there, but... Right.
But was there a specific reason why she would put a hit out on you that you know, okay,
so
this is
why? So I think it
why.
Was Kevin. I think it was her husband, Kevin, because again, Wendy's the one that called me to tell me how to get a job in Philly. Right. She made the calls to
that's
me.
That's why it doesn't make sense.
But it makes all the sense in the world when your husband is controlling and dominating and telling you, Wendy, don't be friends with Jonesy. She wants to be what you want to be. Bitch,
he's
if you
trying
wanna,
to protect his little empire.
He was trying to protect his, you know what I mean? His empire. We see where he is now, and it ain't with Wendy. But he was manipulating, in my opinion, he was manipulating her because she was the one that had the power, you know?
Right.
And she, so, again, I was so removed because I'm like, yeah, but I'm not even going to be in New York much longer because y'all niggas don't know. I'm leaving, big boy's coming. I'm out of here, I'm back in Philly. So I didn't care like that.
But was it any time it was like, yo, because you know, at the end of the day, let me be careful with how I say.
That's serious
but
allegation,
yeah,
that's like serious shit.
At one point, a lot of people were, you know, Winnie's husband was a different type of character.
Yeah.
So was it any point where you felt like that was like, time to protect your life, time
never.
To prove your security.
Never, I'm from Queens, nigga. Come on now. Like, I could have called you. I could have called, come on. I could have called, we from Queens. Right. Come on. I don't know that even Kevin was really outside.
Right.
But I know Southside be outside.
Right.
So I never felt threatened.
Right.
For the record.
Right.
What happened is, and because I was so sidetracked with the other shit, like, you know, like, it's just, it was bigger shit. When we circled back, or when I circled back to, so for all those years, I never reached out to Wendy personally to say, bitch, why you trying to kill me or nothing like that. I was home. I stepped back after Clear Channel, Power 105, but it was Power 99 in Philly, fired me. I said, I've had enough.
For Cosmic Cab and QDZ?
Yeah, big okay. Shout out to them. Okay. I had enough.
Shout out Cosmic Cab.
I'm tired of fighting ex-husbands. I'm tired of fighting radio stations because I had to sue them. I had to sue Radio 1, which is TV 1, by the way.
Whoa.
And so when you feel like you're a married woman and you're fighting corporations and you don't have the support in your marriage, you don't have the support in your family.
That's exhausting.
I had to tap out. Wow. I had left. And I left and I put all that shit into, nigga, get off your phone, I'm praising you. I put all that shit into.
And we saw it, bro.
Into just raising.
They was just reading books, bro.
Yeah.
That's it. Sorry.
That's it. So I put all that, and believe me, it was a struggle, because I'm like, no, I'm going to do. And I actually did. When I left, I started my own online station. It was a 24-hour station. I was doing mornings. I was doing sales. I was doing marketing. I was doing everything.
Right.
And then Hurricane Sandy happened.
In New York now.
It was in Jersey. We were on Jersey Shore.
Oh, y'all got fucked.
Wrecked.
Fucked up New York.
All
Jersey Shore,
the way.
Rockaway, anybody near a beach.
Destroyed all of my equipment, all of my investment, all everything. And at that point, I said, God must be trying to tell me, sit your ass down and just raise your kids. Stop trying to be on the radio, I'm Miss Jones. And
push it in perspective.
Put it in perspective, because I can't outdo a hurricane. So that changed me. Yeah. Like I had to tap into something else and not move with an ego, because a lot of times artists and people in the public eye.
Ego is the destruction of everything.
It's the destruction, but we are conditioned to, if we don't care about our appearance.
No, you need the ego to be in an entertainment business. You need it.
But it's
you gotta control it.
And it's hard because you don't know when enough is enough.
Right.
Or when not enough could have been more, or should have been more. I could have got that part if I had just put my titties up a little more.
Right.
So.
I wasn't ready. I'm sorry.
I'll take a PC break.
Yeah, I got it. I got questions. I'm looking, I'm looking at my cheat notes.
So I checked out. Uh-huh. So for the last 13 years, I was home. No parts of any industry and no parts of anything. And I have also an illness that some people paid attention to throughout the years.
Oh,
it's called ameliblastoma. And it's an aggressive tumor, and mine happens to be in my jaw. Whoa. So if you notice I'm a little puffier on this side and I'm a little twisty, it's because the tumor I've been fighting since I was 13, when I was told, you'll never have a career in singing because your jaw won't allow it. The strength of your jaw is weak. You'll never have a career in radio because that requires talking all the time. You know, I fought through it, but it kind of took me down. And I had to have like 3 more surgeries.
Wow.
After I left radio, it was a lot, N.O.R.E. I went through a lot personally.
Damn, we didn't know none of that.
It was a lot, and it was a lot, and it wasn't all good. Like it was dark.
Wow. And you living in Philly this time?
I got smart because I got tired of selling houses and trying to get. So I'm halfway between both.
Right.
It was a lot.
Oh.
It was a lot.
God damn.
But the beauty of it is,
yes.
You know that energy that's naturally built inside of us artists?
Uh-huh.
When we can't put it here in a song, or we can't do a podcast or a radio show, maybe we put it into our kids. Mm. And my son goes to like the number one prep boarding school in the world.
God damn it.
And he's a 3-sport scholar athlete. He's varsity football, varsity wrestling, varsity discus.
God damn, I don't know what discus is.
He throws some shit. He's throwing shit. Like, he's throwing stuff.
You know, you're growing up better than me. I don't know what the fuck discus is. I'm 43 years.
It's like the
shit you throw?
Yeah, bro.
But you hear how he talks?
I like that.
Yeah, he talks.
I like that. You ain't from Astoria, God damn it. I love that.
Far from.
But go ahead.
So I put it into him and my other son.
Right.
And I'm pleased with the result. And and y'all watch Power.
Yeah.
What's the son's name that goes to choke?
Not the one that killed people.
Yeah, yeah. The son. What's his name?
You know, that's like a pair of
the son in Power. Tariq.
Not Tariq.
Tariq. So
he
could have
been Tariq, you saying?
Yeah, well, Tariq, the boarding school that he goes to. Uh-huh. The same,
But Tariq is a killer, though, right?
And probably him, too.
Yo, so that's not another. We can't see you in the college and kill people. You gotta be good. I'm bugging with you.
So yeah, I put that into my kids.
Right.
And he's great. And my younger son's about to be off to the same situation.
Wow.
And so now I have both arms swinging free.
Wow.
And I'm like, let's go.
Wow. God damn it. Well, congratulations to you, motherfucker. Hold on. I got a couple more. I got cheat sheets right here. Okay.
No, it's good. It's good.
Okay. All right. Damn. This is. All right. I gotta ask this. What? It said recently you were detained for threatening one of your kid's classmates.
What? That's reading
what
now.
Am I walking
it's,
into?
Out, it's out in the thing. Yeah. Tell me what it says, please.
There's this.
That's what, new what happened? Shit.
You started talking about this in your podcast.
Oh, okay. I thought it was on the blog. I'm like, ooh.
No. You put it out there.
Okay, good. Because COVID happened and now I can't go back into court, but I got lawyers and stuff. So,
right.
His brother.
Okay.
You see him shaking his
head? Not you. All right.
His brother.
Little brother?
He's 12, okay. But he runs with a total different crowd of people that he runs with. And so I'm not aware what's going on. I just get a call on my or a text. You're a fucking bad mother. Your fucking son is fucking terrorizing us. You need to fucking kill yourself. You're a fucking.
Wait, who texting you that?
Texting you that? Who?
My other son's enemy.
He's a 12-year-old kid?
It's a 12-year-old... No, it was a 11-year-old girl.
Oh.
But I'm in bed watching Power, and I'm like, who wants to smoke? Like, I didn't realize it was a 12-year-old, and I fucking go all the way in, and I'm like, bitch, you can get whatever you need. I don't give a fuck if you're not.
Take that.
And so her mom...
You think this is Karen?
Right.
You think this is Karen coming right at you? All right, cool.
So then her mom was like, oh. But I called the mom and I was like, your daughter's out of control because she shouldn't be texting an adult.
Absolutely.
Shay always needs his ass beat.
Right.
So I own that. Right. But what I thought we were good. Right. She goes and files a police report and says she threatened to take my daughter over her knee. So now it's not just a case of me a terroristic threat, but it's her daughter against my son. But she didn't realize that her daughter texted him and said, I will fucking murder you with my bare fucking hands. So I told him, screenshot, or maybe I told you, screenshot it for your brother. I called him at boarding school. I'm sorry, Jalen, I fail you.
No, you're good.
Because he had nothing to do with it. He's trying to study. And so but I don't know how to do technology. So he saved it. When we got before the judge, we showed the judge. He's like, oh, he's in the good. The little bitch is in the bad. And mom, you're old school, I get it, but you still gotta show up at court. And then COVID happened, so court hasn't happened, but here's the thing. I'm old school and I will fuck you up for my kids.
This is positive energy, it's called Creed. This is positive energy.
That smells good.
Yeah, it's like, what is it called? I'm sage. It's my version of sage.
Oh.
Yeah, keep going, sis.
I do sage when your dad leaves. No, I'm kidding. This is nice. But the thing is, we live in the suburbs, but I can't change who I am.
Right.
And I don't care if my son is bad, he's bad, but he don't deserve, I feel like some people just take our brown boys. They're so fast to take them to the system.
Right.
Like, so fast, they're still kids first.
Right.
Don't look at them like they're just, those are the...
Right, they don't get the benefit of the doubt.
They don't get the benefit of the doubt of being a kid. So right. I pushed back and fought back, and I'd do it all again if I had to.
So at one point, you and Funk Flex did bump heads, right?
When Remy was beefing with Fat Joe.
Whoa! I don't know, should I go further? Should I go further?
Absolutely.
Yeah. All right, so
don't stop now.
Yeah. So, I had no idea. I had no idea. Can you break that down for me?
So for the record, I love Fat Joe, because had it not been for Fat Joe, I would have...
And you was on Pun's record.
You on Pun's record?
I would have not been on Pun's record.
You have a lot of classic records. Let's stand up and say that.
Come on, make some noise for that, goddammit. Okay.
And I love Joey, because even when we... he's just a... You know, you can
of
have
course,
a conversation.
My brother.
Right.
So what happened? All right, just break it down for us.
Him
for us.
And Remy were in something. Remy
and
is my
power.
Bitch.
Right,
for
right.
Listen.
Right.
Listen.
Right.
And Remy, she was. Oftentimes, women in the industry do not get supported by our brothers. And this was an incident that might have been a difference of opinion or a money thing or whatever it was.
It was a miscommunication. They worked it out later.
But again,
but at this time,
Flex has all the power at the radio station.
Right.
and nights. But now,
yeah, couple days. But at this time, tell me exactly what was it that happened?
I don't know what the beef was, but okay. I know that when you beef with Flex,
right,
and Flex owns the night,
right,
you got to come in the morning because right, I'm the black sheep.
So Remy came to you. So
and Remy started talking that. You know Remy.
I remember the situation. I don't remember the exact content, right? So was this the first time that Remy said something that she was displeased about Fat Joe? This is the first time on your show.
Because they used to always... Because everybody dropped shit on my show.
Okay.
And then I deal with the fallout later.
Describe to us what happened.
She was pissed off. And she's not refined Remy as we see her now. She was like, no, fuck that. He's trying to do this. He's not doing that. Where's my this and where's my that? And you're supposed to be Fat Joe. And it was ugly. It was big. It was bad. And it was on morning radio.
Right.
Morning radio is the top watch, listen to... I tell people this all the time. If you don't want shit to get back, don't bring it to morning radio.
Don't bring it to morning radio.
But back then, you know, I rock niggas to sleep and make you feel comfortable. Right, right. And Remy was my friend, so I didn't have to rock her. I just said, bitch, come tell your story.
Right.
But Fat Joe is going to Flex. And Flex is also, he's the king of nights. Right. So it becomes a battle, and I'm not backing down.
Right.
So ultimately, you know, you think Flex had me, like, let go early? At Hot 97? Is that what you're saying?
You just had an epiphany right now?
Get the shots. No. Thank you, N.O.R.E.
No, I'm asking.
That fucking Flex. No. He's the reason. Okay, so here's the thing.
Because I'm asking. No,
I'm playing, and Flex really did
guard each other. But I did not really. I didn't just put two and two together, but you just put. I'm winning with another shot, too. Where you at, Mr. Lee? Yeah, I'm with that. Well, hold on. Is that what you think happened?
Yeah, yeah.
Because when I was leaving hot,
Mr. Sunny.
Even though...
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Pour the shot. It's right here, Sunny.
We got Mr. Sunny now.
Yeah. Sunny D.
I like Sunny D.
Mr. D.
Thank you. Appreciate you. It's odd because on my leaving of Hot 97...
You want to look at his arms.
Let me do that with wine, bro.
Pour shots. Let me see. I am French.
All right. So go ahead. All right, cool.
So is Jalen. So is my son Jalen.
He's French?
And he speaks it, yeah.
He's
Asian? Yes. And he speaks it with his grandma, like he's from birth. He knows how to.
Oh, shit. You just gassed Sonny the fuck up. You just activated Sonny.
And him and his grandmother
up.
Have conversations. I don't know what's happening.
That is the wrong thing to tell Sonny.
Really?
He loves everything Haitian. Oh, you did it.
Yeah. Yeah, that's him.
Thank you, Mr. Sunny.
Yeah.
All right, what were we talking about?
So,
upon
my leaving,
I'm sorry.
It was your idea to take the shots.
Yes, it was.
FYI.
I didn't drink nothing on the plane.
Good. That's good.
The bitch next to me ordered Zinfandel, right? And then she looked at me like I was going to judge. Bitch, I'm
the
not
pink
judging.
Shit? No, let me drink.
You're like, I'm going to drink champs.
Saving, right. Yeah. I'm just saving for drink champs. So, I knew when I left hot, I was going to be in Philly. I was good.
Right.
BET started meeting with me before my departure. Reginald Hudlin.
Okay.
He was like, we would love to do a show with you. Mm. I said, I'm leaving hot. We don't care. We want to film the departure. I said, okay, here's what you don't know. I'm pregnant. Mm. That's a bonus.
Wow.
We love babies. Can we come into the delivery room and document? And I'm like,
damn.
I don't even want my husband there. Of course you can come.
Right.
So they start coming up to Hot 97 the last few weeks of me being on there. And the rumor is that maybe Flex talked to Ebro and said it may not be a great idea for the company to be doing this when she's about to leave. And I get it.
Right.
I get it.
About to leave and you're pregnant? Okay.
So that's the only thing that I ever could feel that maybe Flex did, because other than that... He was always a supporter. He always has great advice.
Right.
And he's always like...
But Flex is my brother, and I love him. But Flex is a company man. He's going down with the ship.
Yeah. Mm.
Like, he's said that he doesn't care. He'll take less money at Hot 97 to stay at Hot 97.
Wow.
Just to be that loyal.
And look, he's weathered the storm. He's still working after all these years. My ass, I've been fired. What? Fire her, bring her back. Fire her, bring her back. So he's... Obviously, there's something to that.
Right.
But
what do you think when Angie left? Because, like Angie and Flex was, like, they were, like, the two, like, staples of Hot 97.
Yeah. I think that had it not been for Envy leaving, And Angie might still be at Hot.
Whoa. Because Envy leaving and making it work? Because it's not like Envy just left.
Envy left and made it work and okay. showed the possibility. Envy right. saw the painting on the canvas when it was blank. Mm. A lot of people, they believe it could be better on the other side, but they're not quite ready to take that move.
Right.
Envy's a risk taker. He took the move. And the other side is, Ebro wasn't willing to give Envy what he knew he deserved.
Right.
Now, Envy had all that money from that lawsuit clear, from right? Star.
Damn, you good.
Queens get the money,
Damn,
Norby.
You good. That's exactly, we right here. That's exactly what I'm about to say. Like, all right, cool. Let's just be clear. It was a bad joke, again, on the morning show's behalf. I don't want to repeat what allegedly happened.
Well, it started with me.
Okay, no. Please.
So, Star started talking about you, Jalen, being a bastard child. Jeez. And then Power was running commercials all weekend about how this whore had this bastard child.
He was
asking people at the hospital you were born in to send our medical records.
Man, we're sorry, man. We're sorry again.
Yeah. I need a shot for sorrow.
Let's do it.
I need a sorrow shot.
I wasn't ready for this.
Sorrow. He's
Asian.
I'll do it myself. I got it.
All right.
I'll do
all right.
Shot.
So wait, because we got way too deep. Keep going.
He was calling him a bastard.
You got your shot?
Oh no, Mama Juana.
I did a heavy pour. I did a heavy pour.
Okay, that's cool.
Can I do it in two instead of one?
Yes, okay.
Okay.
Oh man, my shit.
Holy shit, because I ain't know what's going to get. Wait a minute. I ain't know what's going to get.
Because it's a lot. And again, you're told, don't talk about that on the air. Let it go and don't bring it in.
Okay.
So he had commercials and promos. Wait.
Yeah. I like his
style. As if I need.
All right. I like his style. So he had commercials saying what?
About your son. That's crazy.
About me being a whore having a child out of wedlock. And that he's Down syndrome, and to send the people at the hospital where he was born, please send the medical records and I'll give you money.
No.
I'll say allegedly, because you have to nowadays.
Y'all radio people, I think hip hop beefs is nothing compared to
this. Yeah, I think we learned it from radio.
Like rappers beefing with rappers? Yeah, I mean, until it goes to the streets. This shit is wild, man.
I would have no idea, like, the way you just broke it down, I had no idea.
There was a murder hit on you. Now I believe it.
Not so much before.
No, now I believe it because this shit is getting deep, man. Talk about family, doing commercials.
It was a lot. And so the whole weekend, remember I told you about the news cycle on Friday?
Right.
No one's reading, so everyone's hearing, but no one's like calling and complaining because people, advertisers that would, they're on their yachts.
Right. So this story comes out. Star is coming up with this, and then...
Wait. So I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. Yeah.
There's something you said that just resonated with me. It's the advertisers that are not going to hear it. It's not necessarily the listeners. It's the advertisers. Ooh. Okay.
So they're playing promos over the weekend.
I didn't catch that at first.
But you caught it now.
Right.
You get the play.
Right. Yeah.
And so the commercials are playing. They're playing all weekend. And people are barbecuing, and they're hearing these promos because everyone's tuned in to Power and Hot and Hot and Power. And he's saying that my son is Down syndrome, which even if he were, it's still like a kid. Like, don't be talking about kids. They didn't ask to be.
And this is after he did the Envy thing? Or this is before?
Oh, this is before. This is what started it.
All right, so he basically got away with this. This is the reason why he kept going with Envy? Is that what we're saying?
Well, Envy, after that weekend, Envy heard it and came in, once again, to my defense.
Right.
And was like, how dare he talk about Jalen and you like that and the station run commercials and promos.
Shout out to Envy,
that
man.
Nigga, that was Power 105 who's doing that. And Envy's at Hot.
Envy's at Hot still. So Envy defended me.
This is such an ill story. Like, this is... So Envy, you and Envy is at Hot 97.
And Star is kicking my back and my son's back and calling him a Down syndrome.
It's like Crypt and Blood shit. Like,
yeah.
I was a blood and didn't know it. Or a Crip and didn't care. Right.
You're banging on the air.
It's real shit. Wow.
It was going down, but because radio was, the beast was bigger than even hip hop beast, I'm just going.
Wow.
So Envy's like, why isn't Jalen's dad saying something? I'm like, well, I had a meeting with him and the uncles, and they feel that me ignoring him is the best thing to do.
Right.
Envy goes, fuck that. He goes on the mic the next break and breaks Star down.
Right.
Star now has his ammunition. Because all along, Ebro had been telling me and Envy, don't respond. Star is just trying to get a reaction. Don't do it. Envy said, fuck you. Somebody needs to stand up for Jones. Envy goes in. Star goes back. Envy goes back. Star. So now it's bigger than me, Nino Brown.
What?
And they're going back and forth with each other. And Star went further than he should have gone. And said about something Envy's about daughters. Envy's daughter right. wiping her ass with mayonnaise and taking a bite out of it, allegedly. And but because we had gone through Tsunami, and Envy's wife is of Asian descent, we knew to play. So Envy went to the same man, or had his wife go to the same man, John Liu, and said, look at this man and what he's saying about my kids. Their mother's Asian, they're black. Like, if you gonna fight us for Tsunami, bitch, stand up the same way. And he did, and Star had to get fired, and Envy got like millions and millions of dollars, and sorry, Jalen, your dad made a bad call. Could have been us.
Yeah, we've been saying sorry over here.
It's all right. We coming back now, right? The comeback?
Yeah.
Comeback.
We coming back.
We coming back.
We back.
And so we back. And so that's what happened. That's what fueled that whole Envy and Star. And people think, oh, Envy's a snitch. You're not a snitch when you're protecting your children. Because there are a lot of crazies out here that will hear someone say something and it's a clarion call to let me go and shoot his daughter. Or let me go and wipe mayonnaise between her ass and all those things. So Envy, he did, I feel, the responsible thing. And after that, Star got fired from Power 105. And then soon thereafter, I think I left. And then Envy wound up where he wound up. But then he wound up at Power. And I don't even know how we got here, but that's what happened.
At what point do you guys all feel that, or do you ever feel, that y'all are just pawns in these corporate people's game?
Never. Because the money's so good.
Because y'all just fighting their fight.
Yo, I ain't gonna lie. I love that answer. I ain't gonna lie. I love that answer.
But it's understood, though. Really? The fight is they're just, it's these corporations are vying for advertisement, and then you guys are taking it to the streets.
Well, to the point of us not getting corporate money like the corporate is, we were minding our business having our kids. You're the one calling them autistic and Down syndrome. Like,
no, you're saying though they're hosts.
Right.
Right, but I'm trying to say, like, why are they going that low? Why y'all have to respond? Like, at the end of the day, these companies...
And the company...
Nobody's saying nothing about the executive dude at the top
right.
and his kids.
Right. Because you know that would be shut down.
Right.
So they probably knew, this is great ratings. Oh, this is great. But we're caught up in emotion. Do you know what I mean? Like, we're protecting our image or our children or our kids' future. We don't want them... Like, you protect your kids.
Right.
And you're not thinking of, oh, but this is really a ploy by corporate...
Well, you can at that point. I'm just saying, before you get to that point, like, why is everybody even allowing it to get to that point?
That's a good point. Yeah. I think we need another shot.
I'm in. But like,
and that's...
I'm in. But like, Peter Rosenberg. We had Peter Rosenberg.
Oh! Peter Rosenberg. Oh.
Whoa.
Ask me.
What, you read books with him too?
No. I saw him on y'all show. Yes. And I was like, oh, really?
And he said that, you know, he felt like you didn't like him. You felt like he said he was an implant for Ebro.
And he admitted to it.
He admitted to that shit. He said, and
he said truth, without knowing he was.
Bitch, you knew you wanted to be on air. If nothing else, you knew you wanted to be on the morning show. But I'm from Queens, and I knew you wanted to be on the morning show.
The writers saying, we just writers.
Right. You knew the end play. I saw the play. I'm not new. Who wouldn't want it? And so Ebro brought him.
You said he's with women wouldn't it? What'd you say?
I said, who wouldn't want
it? Oh, who wouldn't want it?
Who wouldn't want the morning show?
Okay, yeah. That's very true.
And so when Ebro brought him to my attention, I asked Ebro, what's his background? Because again, it's all business. I want to win. So whoever you bring in, short of them doing a Tsunami song, right. I'm here for it.
Right.
When he brought him in and I interviewed him, his credentials didn't necessarily match up with the position.
Because he was making like college do-overs. Like, what is it called?
Parodies.
Parodies. He was doing college parodies.
Right.
Okay.
And I'm at a point in my, because by this time our show has been on for at least 2 or 3 years. Uh-huh. I need next level.
Yes. Right.
Parodies got me in trouble.
Right.
So as I'm talking to him and I'm interviewing him, and of course there's a raised eyebrow. Yeah. So after Tsunami, let me just explain that me, Envy, and Tay had become like this because we realized
but
we
could
trust.
But now Ebro was hired. Is Ebro hired after that? Because
Ebro had been hired. When Tsunami happened.
But he was like the MD. Like he, I used to play pool with him all the time. He was like the MD. Great guy. Still
music
a great guy.
Director.
In my opinion.
Right.
In my
right.
opinion.
He is.
Like, I have no bad stories about Ebro. I mean, like,
right, no,
like,
Ebro is, like, cool.
Yeah,
like,
he's
even
a good,
though
he's
like,
a good dude.
Like, to me,
no
too.
Story,
no, he's good.
So, but by the time, he's the MD.
He's the MD.
Right.
Actually, no. Yeah, he's the MD. And John Demick is the PD.
Okay. So, he comes.
So, he comes because the tsunami rocked my morning show so badly that we needed someone that was completely uninvolved in our shenanigans.
What?
Ebro enters.
What?
To be, and then we hire Todd Lynn, and then we hire Garfield, the comedian, just to have a lot of shit going on so you guys forget about all the bad things that were attached to us before.
Right.
Corporate comes to him and says, you can't be PD or MD and be on the morning show. Make a decision.
Cause so, all right, so let me just ask you something. He's coming from California.
When he came, I was in Philly. Tracy did that.
No, but I'm asking you, was he on a station in California?
Yeah, he was in something in the Bay Area.
And still being the MD? And still being the PD?
No. He been quit that. When Tracy called him to come to New York, he was done with that.
Okay.
He was in the office at Hot 97, but he stepped up when they wanted us off the air for Tsunami.
So is that weird? Because, you know, this is the, like, Tracy Clarity didn't do that. These other PDs didn't do that. Is that weird? I'm sorry. Am I asking, like...
No, you're not.
I'm not asking, like, too much of the good questions. I'm sorry. Like, I see your face.
Because it's totally weird.
It's weird.
That your program director...
Your program director.
Becomes part of your morning show.
This is exactly what Suge Knight was talking about. If you come to us, you know, your Pete, your
all up in the videos, all up in the morning shows. All up in the morning shows. But at that point, we were so desperate and concerned about salvaging our show, and we knew that Ebro had done radio in the sack, that we're like, we just need competent
just
bodies.
And for people who don't know, Sacramento.
Sacramento, sorry.
Yes, okay.
I'm sorry.
Yes.
He had done successful radio in Sacramento, so we just needed competent bodies in the room that we could trust to keep the engine moving forward. But it came a point where corporate came to him and said, you're great in mornings, and you're great as a program director, but you need to pick a side, nigga. What you gonna do? So he said to me, it's up to Miss Jones. And I said, I wonder if this was bad. I wonder if things would have been different had I not said this.
Wonder what you're about to say.
He said, it's up to Miss Jones. You want me on your show or you want me to go back to the office?
Okay, let's just be clear. This is a very big moment. But you're about to answer, so I want you to... We say in Spanish, es comete. Because I want you to be clear what you want to say. You saying that there was a time where Ebro had a chance to go back behind the desk or be in front of the microphone.
The microphone.
And he said, it depends on?
It's up to Miss Jones, whatever she wants.
And what did you say?
You're more useful to me in the back office, so I can know what the white boys are thinking. But had Ebro told me his sincere intention or desire to do radio?
What do you think his sincere intention and desire?
Well, he brought in Rosenberg, and we saw that play. It's the, let me throw you off with Big Boy, and I'll put Rosenberg with Cypher, because I know that's going to fail, and then I'll slide in. It'll be me and Rosenberg. And that's where they are now. Mm. But had he told me... But sometimes men don't want to admit to women a sense of power over, do you know?
No, you're so, going over my head.
So if I'm a woman and I have maybe part of your fate in my hands, that's like a play that you like kind of have no control in. Women tend to be sometimes emotional, Jonesy even more. So I'm not sure he felt comfortable telling me that he really wanted to do morning radio alongside me, or maybe he just wanted to take it over. But the point is, he brought Rosenberg in under the guise of being a producer for me, when all along...
Same way as Whitney Van Winkle, what's the new name? Opie, what's the name?
Opie and Anthony.
Rip Van Winkle? I don't know. I thought about the drink.
Rip Van Winkle from this motherfucker, yeah?
Opie
Van
Winkle. Should I take a nap? 30 years. Should I go to sleep? Rip Van Winkle?
What was his name? Opie
Rick
and...
Delgado.
No, but Rick Delgado. But he was the producer of... Opie and Anthony. Opie and Anthony. All right, so he brought in...
He brought in...
Rosenberg. At the spa.
Well, even if he wasn't going to be utilized as the spy...
Yes.
He damn sure wasn't going to be producer.
Well, that's what but Rosenberg's admitted
yeah, Rosenberg
to that.
Said that. He admitted it. He admitted it.
But that's how
he's like,
they...
He's like, Miss Jones read me. He picked you up, though.
No, I saw him. I said...
He picked you up.
You fuck. Thank you, Peter. Me and Wendy never wanted to like you, by the way, but right. You have integrity.
All right.
But I saw the play.
Right.
I'm from Queens, you know, right. So I knew... You don't have producer credit.
Right.
Ebro is the only one co-signing you. Ebro's the only one that knows you. Right. And here you go. If Ebro had said that I have interest... If Ebro had just told me he wanted to do mornings... Nigga, come on. You rolled with us during Tsunami. Come on, right. You saved me. Come on.
Right.
But he was like, oh, it's up to Miss Jones. So here I go. Well, nigga, I need somebody in the back office to tell me what's going down.
Now, do you think that play, when he actually picked you, you picked him in the back office, was that something that he was like, oh damn, Miss Jones?
I didn't pick him.
I thought you said you had a choice.
You had
said.
A choice to say.
Oh, at that point. Oh, yeah. Well, I don't know. What do you think?
I'm asking you.
I don't know.
And you were doing whatever he might have been doing with Rosenberg, in all honesty.
But what should I have done? I don't know how to better have played that. Because I'm feeling like... Me and Ebro were cool. Like, Ebro knows. Like, he knows all the... He knows where the bodies are buried with me. Right. So if you feeling that you want to do mornings, nigga, tell me. Because they asked... Corporate wants me to give them an answer. Right. He's like, no, it's completely your decision.
And he's the MD at the time.
He's the MD... Actually, he's the PD at the time.
Oh, he's the PD and he still has...
And I didn't feel ever like he was my PD. I always felt like Ebro always made me feel like we were, like, creative equals.
Peers.
Wow.
Right. So I'm feeling like he would have told me, because I used to tell him stuff. Nigga, I need that billboard. Or Ebro, you know, can I get this? So I figured he would have told me if he really wanted to land on mornings.
Right.
But he never did.
He never did.
And so I'm seeing Rosenberg, fuck you are, coming out of nowhere, bitch, please. You ain't get. I'm from Queens. Look, I'm from Queens, nigga. No, bye. So.
Embode, coño.
What you say?
Embode.
Yeah. Over that.
Yeah, exactly. Continue, continue.
Can I pour another drink? A shot?
Please do whatever you want.
Finish the one you got, bitch. Pour him another drink.
This is the one.
You want to talk to yourself too, but yeah, yeah.
This is your show, Jones.
No, you're helping me figure out my life.
No, this is beautiful.
You are figuring it out on your own. You just talk to yourself, and it's amazing.
My therapist said I'd be having a lot of shit in my head. I just need to sort it out. So can I come here like once a month on your couch?
Yes, you can. Hold on.
Let me just be our co-host. Let's do it.
All the people you put on. I got a note of this shit. Hold on.
I love it. I'm trying to get checks out of them niggas.
Hold on, yeah. Hold on.
Who you holding on for?
Ebro, why you didn't tell me, Ebro?
In the meantime,
I got you a producer way better than Rosenberg.
Let me tell y'all, in the meantime, right. No, hold on. In the meantime, I have like three different numbers on Moni Love, right? So the one I decided to text, FaceTime on Drinks Champ with Miss Jones. Cool. We talking about Tupac stories. Percent. Wrong number, motherfucker.
We will never. That's one of those things.
We leaving it alone tonight, too. I still remember she gave Rosenberg, Donnell Rollins, Stephen A. Smith, Mike Sean, Todd Lynn.
Yeah, oh my God, rest in peace.
And all
them motherfuckers is working, and I'm trying to get back in.
They all owe you, goddamn. You let the mafia boss. Woo. They got to come. They got to come and pay homage. They got to come and pay homage. But, whoa. All right. We spoke about Stephen A. Smith. Donnell Rollins. You worked with Donnell before he met Chappelle? Or did he meet Chappelle and he just wasn't lit? And he just came. How the fuck you met Donnell Rollins?
No, I think he wasn't Ashley Larry then.
I don't think he had been Ashley Larry then. Yeah. I don't think so neither.
No, and so Donnell has a, so I love comedy. I love laughing. But Donnell has a very specific and direct sort of comedy.
Yeah.
And it didn't always translate on radio. And morning radio more specifically. Okay. Because just like late night talk is different than The View and The Talk and all those, you have to, I can't describe it, but there's just a certain element. You have to know what works for that day part. And so Donnell, as talented as he might have been for maybe a nighttime show, I just didn't feel like it always showed up for mornings. And then he would get upset, he would get mad, and me and Envy would take bets about whether or not he could read copy without making mistakes, and that didn't help.
Donnell got beef with the Breakfast Club to this day.
Does he?
Is it serious? It's not serious.
Didn't it start from you guys? All right.
No, because Angela Yee is like partners with him.
Yeah,
right. But Angela's, I think, the one excluded from the beef.
No, he got Angela Yee a little bit. But continue. You said Donnell, you and Envy was the first person to put Donnell on. Continue. Talk about that.
And so, like, he would come, he would show up to work, and like, we'd try to let him do his thing in the confines of we still got to do a show. It's not like a one man stand up. He would get upset. He would get really upset, just in between breaks.
Donnell Rollins.
Yeah. Very emotional, but very talented. And most artists are emotional. So I got it, but nigga, it's a 4-hour show. Yeah. Let's just get the fucking white people's checks. Why are we going all out? The fuck? And so he looked at it as maybe a woman telling him what he should be doing as opposed to what he was doing, or Jonesy, who the fuck is she? She's not, I don't know. All I know is that day he did something and it wound up melting down and Ebro couldn't fix it, and Envy, who's the fixer, he's like the Olivia Pope of radio, couldn't fix it. He walked off the show and that was it. And I was like, good riddance. Now, in hindsight, great talent. Never said anything personally bad to me or offensive to my family. It just didn't work for what we were already under the thing of Tsunami. We were trying to build back. We were trying to prove ourselves. And I can't have somebody fighting with me every day when I'm telling you what we need to be doing for the people.
And we talk about
Donnell Rollins and me. So I fired him.
You fired
him. I fired him.
Damn. I'm not sure if we make noise for that. I just say.
No, you don't make noise for the firing.
Right? Yeah.
Come on, guy. What's wrong with you?
I don't know.
We're not making noise for firing somebody.
Nah, I'm sorry. Even though
you did it.
He got me back, though.
How did he get you back?
3 weeks ago, me and Wendy. Williams.
3 weeks ago?
You and Wendy.
After all these years.
Y'all went to Dave Chappelle party?
We went to Donnell Rollins did Caroline's opened up for the first time.
The comedy.
And she called and goes, Jonesy, this is why you need to move back to New York. Donnell Rollins.
Wait, Wendy's calling you?
Yeah.
After the murder hit?
So.
You spent the night at Crib and everything.
Everything.
Yeah, you spent the night at Crib. Did you realize he's way more loving than me? Like, listen.
That's what Envy said. Yeah. Envy's on, whenever I go to Wendy's house, he's like, okay, well, just call me.
Yeah, in the event,
I got to get
make sure.
You.
It might be the last time.
Right. He said, I feel like you my daughter going to the prom. I'm on waiting.
Real shit.
She calls and she's like, Caroline's is open. This is why you need to move to New York. I want to go see Donnell Rollins.
I love
Rollins.
Her impersonation. Her impersonation is it. All right, continue.
And how long will it take for you to get here? So I'm like, it's your lucky day, bitch, because it's Thursday. And Thursday, I tape my show with Queens Flip.
Right.
Me and Miss Jones on the Queens Flip. I'm drinking a lot.
Whatever. We begging the Queens Flip.
Yeah. So I'm already in the city. Yeah, she don't know. I'm already in New York.
Yeah, right.
So she's like, my driver's downstairs. Let me know when you get here. So we go to Caroline's. When we get there, we're a little late, like a lot of late. But so they asked, do you want to sit here or do you want to sit up front? You know, I'm an upfront bitch. I've been at home for like.
Right.
So she's like, let's go. We sit up front and Donnell Rollins stops the show to go, is that Miss Jones, my former boss that fired me? When your boss shows up to your new gig. So he got me. He made a few jabs, but I was like, just make sure you funny tonight, nigga. He didn't go hard. So thank you for not going hard.
But you went Wendy Williams.
I went with Wendy.
Let's just be clear.
He ain't say nothing about Wendy?
Let's just be clear.
Well, he said, so people were going, how you doing? Everybody in the audience was going, how you doing? So by the time we sat at our table, which is right in front of the stage.
A million how you doings.
So he's like, and Wendy Williams? So everyone stands up, and they're applauding, and they can't believe it because last they heard, she was trying to murder you. Right!
All right, but let's be clear. That's the crowd and how they feel. How do you feel with your ex-murderer? I said that wrong.
Ex-murderer.
Stoney and Sosa sitting together, man.
I did not mean it like that. But even if this is allegedly or if it's not allegedly, this is a story that brewed in the goddamn public eye.
It brewed.
And you semi-believed it, let's be honest.
I did. But I felt at the time that my husband, who I told you was in the streets.
Right, and he was cool. He was like,
he said, I got it. Right, and I never heard any more blowback from
him. And him and Kev knew each other?
Well, they got to know. Well, so whoever my ex-husband knew that touched Kev, supposedly Kev was touched. And the problem was over.
Like, touch, like, stop it.
Right. Like,
I'm sorry. I don't know what touch means.
It means, like, stop it. Let's stop it.
Right.
Stop it.
Right.
You know. You need to stop it, man.
Hey, I've been stopped in a long time ago.
I'm on a t-shirt. Street. You know, so
you see what Jamie said? Fully forgives Wendy for even thinking about it.
No, I didn't. Here's what happened. So look.
I love your honesty.
Fuck her because.
Oh, shit.
No.
You just went to the
Fuck her.
She's
because.
Dead. No,
fuck Wendy because here's the thing. So after all these years, right, she never bothered after Kevin did all that shit that he did.
And you knew what Kevin, was a scumbag?
I told Wendy the day I met Kevin, because she asked me to come and approve him. And when she got out of the car to go into the store.
Kevin was kicking it to you.
No, he wasn't. But he was like, yeah. I said, you know, Wendy's going to be big one day. She can't have regular nigger handling. You need to step it up. And he said, I know. And when she blow up, I'm going to be right there. You ain't got to tell me twice what that looks like.
Ooh.
But I told Wendy, and I guess she was like, it doesn't matter, Jones. He probably had so much more.
I love her impersonation. Every time she say Wendy.
It doesn't matter, Jones. Yeah. I'm marrying him. And so, you know, as a friend, you're like, you don't want to be that bitch that's be like, no, don't fucking marry him, bitch, no.
Yeah.
So I was actually at the engagement party. And so he put wedges between us throughout the years. You know, whatever. I did. She was on BLS. She would take jabs, whatever. Her and Star, enemy of my enemy is my friend. Everybody tore me down. But after her divorce, which is recent, and her mom passed away, which is also recent.
God bless.
Yeah. And then I came back on the scene in February. So I'm on IG Live, and someone asked about the murder. And I'm telling them, someone added Mr. C, Don't ask me why.
Mr. Season the Murder now? What the fuck is going on? Mr. Season,
DJ for Wendy Williams. DJ. What?
So somebody in that live, some random person added him. Next thing I know, he's requesting to be cammed up. Ooh.
That's okay. That's the, that's a dead homie.
I'm sorry.
Dead homie's one of those.
Right.
Dead homie's one of those.
And so I cam him up. He's like, what happened? What y'all talking about, Wendy? And I told him, I said, I never got resolve. Like, why would you let that nigga in, like, influence you to have me taken out? Because even if he wasn't...
You're talking to Mr. C on live?
Yeah.
This is live? You're talking to Mr. C saying, like, Kev influenced Mr. C. Mr. C, you thought Mr. C was down with it, too?
No, he knew. No, we all knew at Hot 97 what Kev and Wendy were doing because they were at BLS at the time.
Ooh.
And so I said, anybody trying to get in favor with Kev or Wendy could have taken that murder thing seriously and killed me or my kids. Just trying to get
even
in with
little
that.
Homie.
Like someone somebody, down with them just inspired by whatever the fuck they were talking
somebody
about.
Somebody just want to say, what are you doing all day? Right. Like, you know what I mean? Yeah.
That's
what are you
doing? Real. Bomb. Right.
It's
real. Right. Anybody. So he said, a lot of shit that Wendy, a lot of shit was Kevin and not so much Wendy. And he said, Mr. C is saying, when I did what I did with the transvestites, allegedly, that was all Kevin.
Wait, how did that get involved in this?
Because he's on the live saying, he's trying to explain to me that it wasn't Wendy, it was more Kevin. That Kevin was pushing Wendy to push that whole transsexual, transvestite, whatever the fuck it was, narrative.
On
against,
C, though?
Yeah, because...
I'm so confused. Right
because, now. Listen, you'll get it. When Wendy went to BLS, she's opposite of Hot 97.
Right.
Kev allegedly wanted Mr. C to keep riding with Wendy. C's under contract at Hot, so he can't. Kev gets mad. So now Kev hates Mr. C. Let me put a battery in my wife's back to talk about Mr.
Oh,
C's.
To talk about
him. Oh, that's why Wendy did. Okay. Wow.
So put that out.
Right.
Right.
Holy moly guacamole. All right.
So she used to say, DJ, which we know DJ, is DJ Mr. C. Right. And she would say all this stuff. But to the point, when he came on that live that night with me and Queens Flip, he said a lot of that shit was not Wendy, it was Kevin. And I know it's easy to like blame Wendy now because she's going through this whole public humiliation and blah, blah, blah. But I think if you and Wendy would talk, y'all could find some resolve and either decide to be friends again or to walk away. So he said, do you want me to call her? And I'm like, sure, whatever. He calls her, and he I guess it was a great conversation because he calls me and goes, I know you was at her engagement party. She wants to talk to you. She's like, oh, Jonesy, oh, my God, oh, my God. So he goes, so I gave her your number. She's going to call. So me, I call Envy, Mike Sean, and Mike, Wendy's supposedly going to call me, blah, 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 blah. As we're talking, she beeps in on the other line. So I click over, and she's like, oh my God, Jones, I've missed you so much. How are you? What's going on? And then we talk for like 3 hours. And then 2 days later, she calls and she's like, bitch, I'm on my way to your house. And I'm like, bitch, you ain't got my address. So she's like, bitch, I need it because we're close.
What?
So I give her the address. She pulls up to my house and we sit there for like 4 hours.
It's in Philly, I presume.
No, in Jersey, where I live now.
Okay.
She pulls up to the house. He's at boarding school, but he still has my Ring app on his phone. So he sees every man, every woman coming in and out of mommy's house.
I like his style.
Yeah. So he's like, yo, is that Aunt Wendy? And she comes in and we talk and it just was like...
Wait, it's Aunt Wendy even though the
it's
murder
It's not Murder
shit?
Wendy. It's not
Because on that
Wendy.
Phone conversation...
It's not Murder, Inc.
It's not Murder, Inc. Yeah.
It's not Murder, Inc. Wendy.
It's not Murder, Inc.
Yeah, because I ain't gonna lie. When I Googled that shit, I was like so shocked. Because I remember it back in the days when I had to Google you because you're my friend and I love you, just in case you don't know. You're my peoples.
Yeah,
and
always.
So when I looked at it, I was like, damn, I wanted to forget that. I really did want to forget.
And Envy won't. Envy's like, oh, yeah, okay, whatever. I still got my eye on you, Wendy. Envy won't let it go.
Right.
He's like...
Damn, I don't want to ask this question.
Ask.
People need more friends like Envy.
Yeah, big up Envy. By the way, big up Envy. Big up Envy. But.
Because the next week, she invited me to spend the night at her house.
Yeah, and you did spend the night
at
her house.
And I did. He said, you call me at the first sign of that she trying to get you to take something you don't want or be with somebody you ain't interested in.
I mean,
or,
I think it's probably obvious now that she personally wasn't trying to kill you.
Yeah, no, and she said that. Right, it was an afterthought, which I would have thought she would have led with that.
Had this conversation, you actually did say, yo.
We did, but it wasn't like she led with it, which I would have appreciated more for her to lead with it, by the way, Jones. But it was a, by the way, Jones, you know, Kev was never really trying to kill you. He was just angry. So he said, I'll kill him.
Where's this report come out? The New York Times?
This was in like 2000, maybe 9 or 10. And the lawyer representing Wendy's intern that was suing Wendy and Kevin, Kenneth Johnson, Kenneth, I forget his name. He called and said, I just want to let you know that Wendy and her husband were trying to murder you.
That's pretty.
Kenneth Thompson. But he was representing the girl that was suing Wendy and Kevin. So I said, bitch, why wouldn't you tell me confidentiality to my clients?
Damn, yo.
That's rough.
They fuck me around so much in this industry.
No, hip-hop is fucking foul.
It's bad.
I think radio's really foul.
The radio might be fouler than like the actual artists.
Why do we stay? Why do we
At least the artists are saying in these songs they want to kill you.
Yeah, they want to kill you.
Motherfuckers.
The lawyer calls with the press release.
You gonna die, bitch.
We just won our case against Wendy and Kevin. By the way, they're coming to get you tonight. So... And again, I'm in my own personal turmoil with my own life, so I'm like, fuck that, because I'm not on the scene at that point. I'm like, whatever. But when we met, when she came to my house, she cried.
Wendy. And she come to the house with bodyguards, the bodyguards staying outside, she's dolo.
The hitmen were with her.
She ain't have no, it was nobody. It should have been, because she didn't know what she was walking into.
Right.
It was just a driver.
Right.
And me, and a pop-up, and so I'm in the house sweating like a freaking, and I'm clean sweeping tables like...
Is a little part of you saying, yo, you know what? This bitch might have tried to kill me. I'm sorry.
No.
I'm just saying.
She ain't built. I never thought that she would ever be built, because anyone that saves you when you need a job, when your life is in jeopardy, that to me, that preceded anything anyone could have ever told me, which is why people say now, why are you her friend? Because when I was about to like not know where I was gonna get a check from.
All right, but this is after, right?
And that's
this
your ultimate actually, truth because you lived that.
So she walks in, the other shit is hearsay.
Right.
She walks in your house. Is the first thing she say, that's bullshit?
No, she starts showing me how her titties sit up without a pencil dropping underneath
them. Wait, that's what you guys talk about?
No, I didn't say anything. She walks in and she goes, kids, on Wendy's here. And then she twirls around like Wonder Wendy. And she goes, look at my body. And then she goes, come in, Jones, bring it in. And then we hug. And she's like, what are we drinking? What are we doing? And I'm like, you want the Hennessy? She's like, all day. So we go into the living room.
So Wendy drinks Hennessy.
Does she?
Wendy would do great on Drink Champs.
Yeah, she would do great.
Yeah, have her on.
Yeah.
Clap it up.
Yo, if I can tell you, this is story is so amazing.
So then she's like, so it's kind of like, it feels like someone you haven't spoken to, but you pick right up where you left off. So she's talking about...
But it's a lot of people I ain't speaking to, and I can pick up where I left off, that don't got an article about murder.
They didn't try to murder you, buddy. No murders.
Did I go too far? You know what? Let's just stop this for 1 second.
I got a BB soon.
We got a
Right there.
A pee break. Go, you might as well go.
All right, I might as well.
Hold on, where Miss Jones? Tell Miss Jones.
Where is
Effie? He's here live on the phone.
He knew I was coming.
Yes, he's here live on the phone. Hey, come over here. Yo, Effie, oh, you see, I got my college shit on. You know, I'm, you don't ask me for no cars for your car show, but it's okay. It's all right. You know, I'm up to. You know what I'm saying? But look, Miss Motherfucking Jones. Are you in your car show right now?
Man, I'm getting through for the BET Awards. I'm hosting something for the BET Awards.
God damn it.
Nice.
He getting too much money, Miss Jones. He getting so much money. Look at him.
I'm a black, you know,
Yo, let me tell you something. Ms. Jones bigged you up so beautiful. She so much respects you. She so much loves you. And we respect you. We love you. But I just really wanted you to understand and get your flowers, too. Because... God damn it. Make some noise! Yo, good looking, Envy. You know we love you, man. And you know what? We're going to make sure she get back to having fun.
I have to make sure y'all take care of my sister. Because I'm trying to get some flowers, you know.
All love. I wear flowers. I don't like flowers. I don't want to give flowers. I give out flowers and I wear flowers. But I don't like to give it myself. But yeah, yo, thank you so much, Envy. We appreciate you, my brother. One love. Make some noise. Yeah! Come on, Ms. Joe. Come on. Sit down.
That was so big of you.
Come on. Yeah, listen,
thank
man.
Thank you.
Nah.
No, listen. This is like the biggest podcast in the world. And so, listen, I have been like so excited when I reached out to you and asked. It was because it was like 6 months, or not 6 months, but like 3 months of me saying, I can get on Drink Champs. That's gonna turn my life around.
You're crazy.
This is just so you know.
You never know.
That's wild.
Now, just so you know, we made this platform for us. You know what I'm saying? The thing about it is, we love the new artists, but some of them, you know, they last 2 years, 1 year, and then they leave. And you know, we invented the idea of a hip hop union. And what a hip hop union means is like somebody that put in they work and they, you know, they blood, sweat, and tears, and then after 10 years, your bills should be taken care of. Your whole thing. So this is what me and my partner.
You're doing an amazing job.
EFN is trying to do, and
this is the Grammy of hip hop.
Oh, goddamn. I want to reiterate something I said earlier, was you like kind of invented social media. Like, in my opinion, most things that happen in hip hop, people have to call you, and if they couldn't call you, they would DM you, is the private line.
Right.
I think we established
that hotline or that warm line.
The warm line. But how is that? Because at one point, if it didn't happen on your show, it just didn't happen.
Or it would happen on And Your Flex, maybe.
Okay. Well, let's just focus on you.
Let's
focus on. All right. So at one point, you know, things happen on your show. Was that like a crutch, or was that like, because sometimes people get mad. Artists is very sensitive. So, has there been a time where artists, you reported something and the artist got sensitive on you?
Always. Beyonce's mom.
Wow.
She wanted to fight me, a child. No, I'm not a child. But she wanted to fight me. She came to me in the studio and so...
Talk about Miss Knowles.
Miss Knowles.
Okay,
you must have got her really pissed off.
Yeah, what did you do?
She seems like she's pretty chill.
I kind of like...
You did some Trick Daddy shit. Let's just throw it out there.
We used to do parties. And so one day... And so Beyonce was coming up to the station, but Ebro and them didn't tell me because they knew that I would either try and... I was unpredictable.
Because you did say Mary J. Blige can't sing. You did say that at one point.
A lot of times she can't. I love her on Power. But it doesn't... Nowadays, you don't have to be able to sing. Oh, shit. And that's what I learned. It's not about singing, it's about emotion. Good save. Good save. Right?
I'm clapping, I'm very skeptic.
You're right.
It's about emotion. You don't have to be technical.
You don't have to be the best singer.
Right.
To be successful.
To have a great record.
Because you're who you are, the emotion, the way you convey it.
Mary sells the flow. Brand. Right. She sells the brand of black girl hurt in love. That's it. That's it. Right. You win.
Jesus. God, can you continue? Okay. It's time to bring the Queen's Flip one of the hair. You ready?
You ready? Bring him in.
Come on, G-Money.
Give him a chair, goddamn.
Come on, DJ
Holy
G-Money.
Holy moly guacamole.
It's real hot over there, though.
It's very hot over there. I'm just letting you know.
You'll be fine.
She just said Mary J. Blige can't sing.
I heard that's a little...
Woo.
You're pushing it.
Well, I mean, that doesn't mean that she's not a great artist.
That's exactly what Trick Daddy said.
Macy Gray isn't a great singer.
Right.
Who?
Macy Gray.
Okay.
Oh, well, it depends.
I think maybe,
okay. Her style.
It she's not known into, for her vocal.
If you're into
prowess.
Her voice or not, that, no, it's a different type of voice.
But so is Mary. If you're into it, you're into it.
Right.
It doesn't matter. And the song, the brand is consistent. Mary's brand is consistent. Throughout the years, you know, if you're hurting in love, put on a Mary song. Right. She wins by default, you know?
Yeah, I've been hurting in love for a long time, so I love,
no.
I love Mary. No,
I saw your gorgeous wife.
Well, God damn it.
No, happy belated birthday not, to your gorgeous wife.
No, not recently, but back in the day, I was hurt like a motherfucker.
Yeah,
yeah,
well.
Like, I love her. Come on, yeah. Real love. Come on, God damn it. Come on. So, as you think that you and Mary's beef is because of what you mentioned earlier, where you felt like Papa was kind of like, is it just that or?
Here's the thing.
Okay.
When Mary,
but you
and
still
I,
was mature enough to, when I picked you again. So, I'm sorry, I cut you off.
No,
bro,
it's fine.
But go ahead.
Mary and I have no beef. Like, when we see each other, she's like, you want some wine?
Did Mary ever acknowledge you being one of the first?
We don't
in
have
that
those
genre?
Type of conversations. Ooh. We don't have those conversations, and Wendy and I don't have those conversations. So here's the interesting thing. When
but
I
Wendy tried to murder you, it's a little different.
I don't know.
Sorry, I went too far? I'm sorry. Murder.
Yeah, that murder shit, man. Just the fact that you keep calling it murder? Like it already died. Like a murder happened.
It's different. Like, I swear to God, you know you're my sister. I love you. So when I Googled you and it kept coming up, I was like, damn. I had to. I swear to God, I would have excluded it from the interview. But I kept Googling it every...
It leads.
Yeah,
it leads. Wendy
it
Williams Murder. And it leads
Word.
Now because
Word.
She and I are like out in these streets together Word. Every Word. Chance. There's pictures and stuff like that. And here's the thing. Mary is unaware of, I guess, how I feel. Like, Fab Judah does these celebrity boxing matches.
Yep.
And he wants me and Mary to fight.
Whoa, that's never gonna happen, obviously.
But so I've challenged her. I was like, come get these paws, bitch. It's what you wanted to
Wait,
be. But,
stop,
yeah,
she's
know,
not gonna
fun.
Do that.
I'm not. I need to stretch and like lose weight and all these things, but it was fun. But I think she shut down my IG page.
She shut it down? Like,
probably not. I'm just running with it. But right. I don't have a problem with her. She right. really don't have a problem with me because she's come to my show in Philly.
Right.
We're good. Right. She's not that complex. Right. It's just me with this whole I have a thing. Like, I have a thing.
So you don't think that, if she's questioned and taken back, because it's easy for someone to have a career and in the beginning of their career not acknowledge certain people that are around their peers, right? But after they've had a huge career, they can look back and say, yes, this person
so you're telling
was
me
on
after-
the forefront of this. They were the pioneer of this. They were before me in this. You don't think she'd do that right now?
Get her ass on your show and find out.
No.
Because now that I'm playing, all the bitches is going to try
question.
And come.
Here's the better question. After you guys were competing in music, she's never came on Miss Young's show ever? You never interviewed Mary J.
No, Mary really? Refuses to come. Damn. But she came on my show in Philly.
Okay, that's your show.
But what does that mean? No, I think she didn't realize that it was Jonesy, because in Philly, they call me Jonesy. New York calls me Miss Jones.
No, she realized.
She probably
no,
did.
No, artist not. We're not that. We play
stupid. Mary be drinking.
No. Okay. Yeah. I be drinking, girl. I know Miss Jones from Jonesy.
I don't know.
Yeah, okay. No, I'm a different Mary right there. I think Mary exactly knew who exactly you were. And that was her olive branch.
Okay, well, and I took it.
Okay.
But I still talk my shit. I play too much. They all know. Mary, Faith. Faith's not speaking to me now. Mary, Faith, Lauren, they all know I play too much. But it's who I am.
Right, let's go with Lauren. Who got beef with Lauren?
Lauren Hill?
You got beef with Lauren Hill?
No, I really don't have beef with Lauren. But
the way you describe that. Hold on.
But Faith is mad because she came on my podcast. And it was all going good, and then I got silly, and I was like, who is better in bed, Tupac or Biggie?
Oh, my God.
And the record scratch, like, whoop! And she's like, I wouldn't know. Like, why would you ask me?
I just heard in my head, two Pacs.
Two Pacs. So, like, I just be playing too much. N.O.R.E, help me.
No, I can't. Love this one. I gotta let you drown on this one, sis. That one is terrible. You really asked
It was bad.
Me?
It was bad. But to the point.
Did she take it humorous? No.
Well, in that moment, she actually was like, I didn't have sex with him, and we carried on. Because
Faith on our show was super candid. She was open as a motherfucker.
I saw her.
She had sex with
two. No, she said straight up she didn't.
She said she did.
But I had to ask her. Yeah, she said a lot of shit.
She said a lot of other movies. She didn't say she had.
But I had to ask because that's what I'm known for doing. How could I not ask? And she was fine. She, like, we kept on with the interview, and then later that night, I got an email that CC'd Stevie J and me. How dare you ask me those questions? That was disrespectful of my husband. My husband would not appreciate you having asked those questions. My husband is up. Stevie, get out of Faith's email and go to bed. I know that was Stevie J sending that email to me, but I apologize to the Jordans.
Shit.
Yeah.
I wasn't ready for none of this.
It's okay.
Yeah, let's do another shot. All right.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, it's okay. Did you get a shot, motherfucker?
Yes, please. I mean, we had. We had three champs, you know, I see
motherfucking you.
When in Rome.
Yeah, interview Mano, Tragedy.
Yes.
I watch it all, bro.
I appreciate that.
I watch it all, bro. It
means a lot.
But Flip got to relax. He going to people's cribs.
Do not say Miss Elite pours heavy, because look at what you just did.
After that Mary story and Faith backing up, and yeah, I don't want CVJ coming in with the muscles.
Okay, but here's another deal. I asked you Little Kim or Foxy.
Yeah.
She said neither, right?
You're the first person to ever say neither. Come on, let's do a shot. I like your style. Yeah, your shot of pouring.
I'm ready.
Yeah, all right, you ready? All right. Ah, you said neither. This is the, all right, for lack of a better term, especially our time, especially the time you came out, you were on AZ's number one single. You're on Punch.
She has everybody's record, man.
Yeah.
A lot of records.
So Big Al.
Big Al. Come on. That was a big deal. Yeah.
How can you say Lil Kim and Foxy Brown are not picked either? And I would like, you know what? I love them both, but I would like your God honest opinion.
Here's the thing.
Yes.
We all, as much as we may not want to admit, we know that Biggie was the best writer for Kim. And once Big passed away, the level of lyricality kind of waned.
I love that word. I never heard of it. Lyricality. I mean,
I don't even hear the word, but that works.
Lyricality. That shit hard. That was hard. Go ahead.
Is it a word? Let's Google it. Lyricality.
We need to make it a word.
Make it a word.
Go ahead, continue.
It waned after he passed away. Like, we waited and waited and waited.
For her specifically to step
up. Yeah, right. And I don't know that. And maybe we just had bigger expectations because it was Biggie writing for her. But when she finally did, it's a word.
Lyricality.
Go ahead, Jonesy.
God damn, go ahead.
It felt right, SU.
All those books you've been reading.
Go ahead.
Right. So I just, and Foxy is personal. It's personal.
Well,
she's just,
you need to hear the person.
She's just nasty. She's just mean for no reason to me or back then. Like, just, like, irrational, and I can't do it. I can't do it. I don't care how much your flow is good and who you affiliated with.
Rumor was that, I don't know. I'm crossing a line. But rumor was, like, AZ was, like, her quiet man on her low. You did a record with AZ. Did that have anything to do with it?
An epiphany again.
I had no idea.
We took a shot.
It's a rumor. Allegedly.
That would make sense.
It's a rumor.
Because I didn't know that girl. I didn't know that girl.
Allegedly.
Allegedly. That would make sense.
Each other out. Yeah, right?
Both. Exactly.
That makes sense.
Exactly. I'm clear.
You've been cleared of all your charges.
Wow, N.O.R.E.
This is allegedly.
We didn't have AZ on the show. He's been supposed to.
Yeah, AZ supposed to come on the show.
He's got a new album coming, so he needs to come.
And he's still dope.
We still talk. He's supposed to come on mine, but he's like, Jones, do you know the creative process? That would make sense, because I never knew why. She just is always those ways to me.
This is a legend.
Was it? Well, so look at the timeline. Was it after that?
It was.
Well.
Because I was on the Firm album. I did a song on the Firm album. Yeah. Oh,
your face.
But I'm like, why? I'm amazing. On the album. Yeah. Wow, thank you, N.O.R.E. Can we give it up for N.O.R.E.?
Allegedly.
Do not give me that truth.
Allegedly. Yay!
You gave me my closure that I needed.
Yeah.
Wow, whoever thought it would have come on Drink Champ?
Allegedly.
Allegedly, it happens this way.
You're fucking me up, right?
No, we're allegedly fucking you up.
Okay. You're a pun.
Oh.
Allegedly, too?
This is super allegedly.
Everything is not allegedly. It's me and pun was, like, he was my love story.
What?
Yeah.
No.
We never fucked.
Oh.
But we could have.
Oh.
But we didn't.
Jesus.
But we, that's a love story that's like.
So you were in love with him without fucking?
So here's the thing. When I met Pun.
Well, I knew I didn't have to ask the story.
Rest in peace, big Pun, by the way.
Thank you, sis.
Rest in peace.
Thank you.
That was really sad when he died, but so.
I ain't gonna lie, y'all was sorry to the situation, but when I used to see y'all, y'all was cute together. Like he would like rub your nose.
Yes.
Dude, like
rub your nose.
Stupid shit. Yeah. Pun would come to my house every night of the week after like 7 p.m. Yeah. And just be. He would share his.
I'm sorry. This is something. You know what? It's 20 years, 25 years later. Do you think Pun was in love with you?
I know that he was.
Oof.
I think so too.
You do? Why do you think that? No, stop.
Your son is back here. I gotta relax.
I mean, he already heard a lot.
No, but honestly.
It's allegedly,
honestly,
bro.
Honestly, I'm so sorry because, you know, it's people are going to be offended by this part of the interview, but it's okay, and I apologize. But I never see him blush. When I see him around you, I see him blush. And it was like.
She's blushing right now.
He was good to me.
Right.
He was good to me without me maybe even, like, I just was able to be regular Tarsha from Astoria. And he didn't judge me.
I'm crying? It looks like I'm crying? No. I remember how my brother felt about her. Like, I swear to God.
That's genuine.
Like, no. Yeah. That's serious. And he's the guy from the Bronx. I'm supposed to, you know, I'm hers. I'm her brother.
Right.
So when I heard him talk about her, I could not stop him. Because it was so respectful. It was so lovable. And it was so, like, you know, I'm sorry, because I can see her face right now.
It's fine.
No.
It's good.
No.
You're taking me to a good place.
I'm so, okay, all right, cool.
Thank you.
Because I could physically see that. I could physically see when he was around you, like, he felt comfortable. He lowered his thing. And, you know, I apologize to anybody who's hurt from what I'm saying. But I could see that he had a certain part of his heart for you. And did you know that?
I did.
Okay.
And but again, he was always married.
Was it reciprocal? Like, did you feel the same way?
I did, because he didn't want nothing from me.
Right.
He didn't need anything.
It was just pure emotion.
It was pure emotion, and he met me where I was.
Right.
Like, he always was available to me. In the midst of his busy, he always, at the end of the night, that driver would bring him. 55 West End Avenue, apartment 2K.
You know what's the crazy shit? I lived on 53rd and Western Avenue at that time. Chill out, relax, kick you on your story.
Yeah, chill out.
Trust me. I knew.
Okay. So you know. And so he was at the height. And when you're at the height, it's hard to get people to receive you where you are. But he knew I didn't want nothing from him but those laughs. And he knew I was dealing with some mental shit from the person I was with at the time.
Wow.
And he pulled me up out of that. And he did a remix for my album because he knew the label was about to drop me. Mm-hmm. And he said, if I do this remix, not only will they keep you, but they'll send you on tour with me. And I'll threaten them if they don't.
Mm.
And that happened. And Motown got me a tour bus. Next thing I knew, I was the most unworthy R&B artist on tour with Fat Joe and Big Pun.
Woo!
Yeah.
Big up to my brothers.
Yeah. And then, when all this shit happened with Hot 97 and I needed to move from that apartment to Harlem, who gave me first month's, last month's security?
Oh, we've never heard this. We need you to say it.
Yeah. Big Pun gave me first month's, last month's security. Come up to my office, the check will be there.
Wow.
And I never.
No, I always knew it was like.
You know.
I knew it was a deeper love. Like, you know, I'm too young to like identify what it actually is.
Yeah.
But I'm old enough to know there's something there that's like, it's beautiful.
Yeah. So, and we kept it clean.
Yeah, it's right. Never physical.
No.
Which is like, we need to make that clear.
Yeah, no, we never had sex. We never kissed. We never did anything. But.
But there was a
high level of intimacy.
Yes.
Without the sex. Which
that's
is ill. What made it.
That's what y'all young dudes need to understand.
That mental intimacy.
I don't even know why I'm trying to promote that. I'm sorry. Let me leave that alone. But yeah, no, that was real. That's real because, you know.
Thank you, N.O.R.E.
That's my brother.
Because no one ever spoke for his side until now.
No, I knew how he felt about you. I'm sorry. I know they're going to hate me. Like,
I know the family, but they got bigger fish to fry.
That's real shit, man.
Nah. I saw it. Like, you know, this is my sis. So I'm sitting in the back, like, and I'm looking, I'm like, damn. And, like, he would go above and beyond to make
above,
sure Miss Jones
above.
Is great. Like, yo, wherever she at, like, yo, let's go to the Miss Jones session. Like, where are we going? Like, all right, cool, let's go. I'm like, oh, okay.
And
I just love that.
To this day,
yes.
I had no idea he put me down on his publishing.
Wait, I didn't know.
Like his regular, like all his publishing?
I get checks on songs. Should I be saying, wait now, hold a minute. Hold up a minute, wait a minute. I ain't trying to fuck up my shit, but.
I mean, if it's legal, it's legal. It's done.
It was his choice. Right? Right?
Yeah, absolutely.
He put me down. Like, I live, Jalen. You live off of the royalties of Big Pun.
Wow. Did you know that?
Wow. That's beautiful. I just knew. I knew how he looked at her. I knew how he saw her. I didn't know anything else, and I didn't want to know anything else. It wasn't my business. But I could never take away from how he looked at her, how he saw her, how he treated her. Every single moment. So now I'm going to get a little deep. It's going to be a little weird. But what? How did you feel like when he passed away? Like.
You know, I passed out at the funeral and they had to pick me up off the floor.
Definitely remember that after.
It was, we had just come off tour and it was like 2 months later. And, yeah. He was in a lot of pain.
See, you know.
More than physically?
Yeah,
that's what fucks me up is when I went to the casket. That's what the brothers told me. They said he was in pain. I never seen him physically in pain. I saw him. You know, I saw him go to sleep like, and later on I figured out that was narcolepsy.
Narcolepsy,
whatever it is.
Yeah.
But I never seen him fully in pain. So, you know, if you could give me some light on that, you saw him in pain.
So he used to. I mean, we used to have conversations about his relationship with his mom. His relationship with his mom. Well, boys' relationships with their moms, to all you men, it's how you.
All right, I loved how you looked and said boys' relationship with their moms. And
there's
you
a bunch
at
of dudes
all
in
these
here.
Grown
She's
ass
all
men.
Of us. We're all
but,
boys.
But at one
all
point,
boys.
You were boys.
When
you're young, that's what forms your relationship with women, your relationship with your mom.
Right.
Woo. Go ahead, Ms. Jones.
So
go ahead,
he used to talk
school
about.
School us, goddammit.
He just used to discuss and open up about his relationship with his mother. At that time, it wasn't the greatest. And, you know, maybe they needed time to grow. But he didn't live beyond that. So they were still trying to figure things out. And I wasn't judgmental because, like, us as people of color, we are born into trauma.
Yeah.
We're born into trauma and it becomes ordinary. We face trauma. We dress up for the wake and the funeral. And then after like 3 days, we have to go back to work or school like nothing has happened.
Terrible. I understand.
And this is how we're raised. And we grow and it becomes normal. And you don't see that there's shit that wasn't addressed. And so we go through life and then you get older and that shit that's not been addressed.
You just carry it.
You just carry it. So... he was dealing with a lot of pain.
So I just want to ask you straight up. I'm just being honest. because this is something, a question I cannot get answered. He told you he was in pain?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
And he told me why. And he told me what happened leading up to. And he discussed the weight gain and what prompted that. And he told me when I met Pun, he was not overweight. He was slim.
You made that earlier, Pun. Right.
Mm-hmm.
He like EFN.
Yeah. He was svelte, like very, and he
just fight with it.
And he so I didn't meet the overweight Pun. I met that Pun, and he liked me then. What? But I didn't know he liked me then.
What?
He was in a talent show at the Victoria Theater up in Harlem, and he had jumped off the stage. I was a judge and was doing his song to me. But I saw the talent then,
right.
So I'm giving it up just because he was talented. He remembered. He remembered, I met you, blah, 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 blah. And then some accident happened and a lawsuit.
Yeah,
and
he
then
came
the,
to Miami, yeah.
So you know.
Wow.
But so he would share that with me, and I don't judge because I just don't judge. Like, who the fuck am I to judge? But we used to have barbecues at my Manhattan apartment. Brandy, everybody would come. And he would ask that I put his plate to the side because he knew that people would be watching him while he was eating. And he didn't want that. He didn't want that distraction. He didn't want that, you know.
What?
And I got it because fuck them. I'll put your plate to the side. But I don't know that he had that type of transparency with a lot of other people.
Right.
And he knew he could trust me with it because, again, I ain't judging.
Mm.
So I think that encouraged the love. It was intimacy without sex, without right. physicality, without, oh, I'm a fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. It was none of that stuff. Right. It was just...
There's other people fuck you.
There's always other people fuck you. Right. We talked about a few. All
right.
Circle back. All
right.
I'll never tell.
I know.
But so, you know, so it was like he and he took me on his back, struggling R&B artist, and put me on his song, came on my song, Two Way Street Remix,
yep.
Made Motown get me a tour bus, hotel rooms. Everything, street team, everything. And if it hadn't been for Pun, I probably would have never experienced going on tour.
Wow.
Speak some books. That was beautiful, man.
Rest
it was beautiful
in peace
for,
to Pun,
for me to, like, be outside looking in. You know, I was never, like, in you guys' conversation. I just see you guys just, like, you guys were, like, bump heads.
Yeah, but N.O.R.E, I knew.
I knew it was something special.
That's how you know it was real, because an outsider, which is close to Pun.
Yeah.
All these
and
years
close
later.
To her. And I was just like, all right, when I seen it, I was just like, all right, I always felt back.
Yeah.
And it was a special, camaraderie. What is that word?
Camaraderie, yeah.
Yeah. But, oh, man, this is, all right, so let's go, let's talk about you right now.
What's up, man? I'm here. What's
Queens on? Flip, that's the name of the show?
Flip the Script Podcast.
Flip the Script Podcast. Yes. Okay, so how did y'all get started? Y'all saw us. Let's keep it
yes,
real. Let's keep it real. Y'all sweet drink chat. We lit.
Pretty
no,
much.
No, let's get y'all family.
Much.
No, y'all family. Y'all
pretty
family.
Pretty much.
We love what y'all doing, by
Thank
the way,
you.
Too.
Thank you.
So let's that's the beginning of the podcast?
Yeah, I mean, so me and Queens Flip is, good friends for like 15 plus years now. So I met him. He was doing music. He was rapping. You know, I DJ.
He was rapping.
You can find some songs on YouTube. Sorry, Flip.
Find that.
I didn't know that.
Sorry, Flip. Sorry.
Okay. All right. Is he gonna be mad? Are you? Oh,
he might be a little mad, but
that's
sorry.
Okay.
It's cool. But
he's always mad.
You know, so like
say allegedly.
Allegedly,
he was rapping.
So like many people who know Queens Flip, when you first meet him, it's kind of like he gives you like a little test. Or I call it a test. I feel like everybody who's he's close to, he kind of like presses you a little bit. So when I first met him, he kind of pressed me about playing a song, and we had like a little. I'm like, yo, bro, yo, like get out of here.
You had mixtapes.
Hit me.
Yeah.
Yeah, I had mixtapes, but he wanted his song played at this at Rochdale. It had a Rochdale
Day
in Queens. So he wanted to get his song played.
54.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
So he wanted to get his song played. I wasn't DJing. My friend was DJing. Said like, "Yo, tell your man to play the record." I'm like, "Yo, bro, like, come on." He's pressing me. So from there is when we kind of first started to get cool back then. But the podcast started because I had my own radio show
You used to like Sirius Satellite or no. You used to college radio like type shit. Right?
I was on DTF actually. We actually interviewed you on DTF radio.
DTF, there you go.
So I had you on DTF. We interviewed years ago. So that show stopped, and then people kept saying like, "Yo, you and Flip need to do your own show. That's your man, right? He's going viral, going crazy. Yeah. You and his personality is kind of different. It'll mesh. You know what I'm saying? So we did our first episode about 4 years ago.
And who was that with?
So our first episode, you know, he wanted to come out the gate. You know, his idea was to make some noise and get a little crazy. So
to do with gangsters.
Not yet. The gangsters came a little later. Episode one, we had a girl give a little bit of, you know, hi-ya on camera.
What?
Oh! Yeah. Whoa!
Episode
y'all,
one.
Y'all got head in the whip without crashing it?
Yeah, episode one. You know, because we felt like, you know, the podcast game is going crazy right now. We got people like, you know, Charlamagne, these other guys who are doing shows, Envy, you know, they're doing their podcasts. We kind of wanted to make a name for ourselves. So we started out by interviewing a guy. Why he was
giving? God was giving head.
Well, the guy was receiving. We interviewed him to see head. If.
Wait a second. Wait the fuck a second. So that was the game. That was like,
that
yo.
Was episode one.
But y'all set it up like, all right, you gonna get head while we give you the interview?
Yeah.
Or it just happened.
The guy. So all right, we interviewed the escort, right?
And escort is the guy. Or the girl.
No, the girl.
The girl's so the escort. Girl. We interviewed the escort.
And then the John walked in.
And then he walked in, and we let them set up, let them get comfortable. We left the room, came back in the room, and we started asking her and asking him how good she was, and you know, just to see what if she performing to her abilities. You know what I'm saying?
That's the wrong. The drink champ's pale, man.
That's
a good
one for being John.
You know, so. We went from there to
Eddie the Azzy is gonna have to step it up, man.
Nah, let me tell y'all, man.
Eddie the Azzy is gonna have to step it up.
No pressure.
But then y'all went to the
so from there, gangsters. From there, you know, we had a bunch of other guests in the show, and then
somebody stabbed somebody.
We got to Bimmy. We had Bimmy in the show.
Right.
We had Bimmy. We had Shay Davis. We had Supreme Son in the show. Some people like that, and then. We realized that the audience wanted to see those stories, hear those stories. So we started interviewing all of the
I thought y'all was Don Diva.
I mean, yeah. We had Kevin Charles and
Diva. Every gangster, I kept sending them to y'all. Yes, sir. All of them dudes. I don't want to interview no gangsters. Like, I'm great.
But the crowd, you know, the crowd responded. I think we had our first, like, NYC Blood, the OGs on our show, and the numbers went crazy.
Yeah.
So after that, it's all right. This we got to go. We got to talk to the streets.
Yeah, but doesn't that kind of commit you to that? Like, once you do one of them, don't you gotta commit it to be doing everyone? Because now, all right, cool. This guy says, I'm the NYC Blood. Mm. And his shit does a million. But this one says, I'm the first NYC Blood.
Facts.
Mm-hmm. Now, and then this one says, I'm the first NYC Crip. Like, what does that bring y'all at?
Well, I mean, you know, we don't know who's official, right? Because we weren't there in Rikers and when everything first started. So we get the first guy, and then he co-signs the next guy. Like, yeah, I was there with him.
Then Brooklyn Cav got a co-sign, such and such.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So we go that way. But of course, our phones are going crazy for the rest of the world. Like, oh, I'm the
everyone
first.
Everyone is saying, everybody's no matter how tough you are, there's always someone who says he pussy.
Right.
Mm.
There's always someone tougher.
100%. No matter how rich you are, there's always someone who say you broke.
That's a fact.
No matter how much pussy you got, there's always someone to say that you ain't getting nothing. I went too far, sis. I'm sorry. But you understand what I'm saying?
That makes sense, yeah.
100%. So how do y'all balance that? Because I can't.
Yeah, I mean, you know, like I said, we had guys like Killer Kev and, you know, OG Nook and, you know, Soul B.
Big kind of.
We had them confirm, like, all right, this guy's valid. And then, you know, we try to go to Nietzsche.
There's always somebody that.
Yeah, but after a while, we left it alone because now everybody want to get involved. Everyone wants to.
Because you said the numbers went crazy, so it would allude to that. That's what inspires you to keep going.
Right.
Like, at what point does the numbers going crazy not, like, it becomes detrimental to what you, you know, to the platform?
Right. I mean, you know, like I said, at a certain point, we kind of just slowed down with it. We felt like everyone in New York wanted to get their story heard. And
everyone that's gangster from New York.
Yeah, exactly.
I was so happy that they came to you.
And not you.
I was so happy. I was like, oh yeah, go to these people. Yes. I'm watching everything.
We took it. And I think we went from there to we started interviewing people who just came home that did 20, 30 years and did hear their story about whether they was accused, you know, falsely accused.
There's somebody that always refutes their story.
Yeah, of course.
Always.
Of of course. That's the game. You know, we went from there and just started growing and just getting different guests. And, you know, we kind of ran into Miss Jones. You know what I'm saying? So, down the line
yeah,
somewhere.
Yeah, just hold a whole new show with Miss Jones. They got a whole new show, right?
Yeah, Queens Flip and Miss Jones got their joint on Thursdays.
Come on, let's talk about that.
So it's on Thursday nights. He calls it Me and Miss Jones. I call it The King and I. And we just
not like the group The King and I. Remember the nobody remember The King and I. I thought that was dope.
That
group was dope.
I do.
Well, it was the artist. It was one artist actually.
Right. Okay. But no.
So you and
Flip.
Right.
Yeah.
Thursday nights.
And
let me ask you something because you say you got something on Monday.
That's my reunion show, Miss Jones reunion. If but you want, to
when do you drop your audio of that?
So we tape it Sunday night. Me, DJ Envy from the Breakfast Club, Mike Sean.
I love she flossing on us, right?
Yeah. Sometimes Ebro, you know, he's shady.
He's the recorder. He's the engineer.
He's so shady. No, he comes on the show, but he's like, after he caught COVID, he like fell back, and I didn't want to push.
Okay.
And like, the core of the show is me, Envy, and Mike Sean anyway.
Wow.
So we do every Sunday. Last week we had Remy and Papoose.
Wow.
Envy's on the show every week since the beginning.
Yo, Emmy's really a good guy, man. Queen Flip got to stop coming to his house. He got to stop.
So I just want to tell you that Envy has not shown up for the last 2 weeks because he thinks that I'm down with Flip in these skits. Yeah.
Okay. That's not. Come on, Flip and Envy is playing these skits out.
I'm not there, bro. I don't.
Come on. No one believes it. No one believes it.
So they knew of each other, but their main connection is me. So I'm like, Envy, he's good. And Flip wanted this verse from Beanie. So I introduced that.
But we don't believe this, Miss Jones. I'm being honest. When we see Flip jump over the gate.
But here's what happened. Envy said, come for the verse on Wednesday at 3, right? Flip shows up Monday at 1. So
I believe that part.
Yeah.
Okay, I believe that part.
And then
he showed up early. Early with the bullshit.
But now it's funny. Like, I look forward to the Envy and Flip skits, and I don't know. But Envy's like, oh, he showed me phone records. You're talking to him 20 minutes before he breaks in my house. Mm. He brought a mariachi band, and you didn't say nothing. And so I'm just trying to, like...
I saw all this footage.
Yeah. So the mariachi band.
Do you want some Ace of Spades? I'm being honest.
Can I have a bottle to go?
You can have this bottle to go for you right now.
Yay!
Come on.
I am.
But do you want one to drink right here? Like, a sip?
Because this is going to make me sick.
This is black. Oh, no, not
a little
sick.
Because I was doing the...
Oh, which one? They said a little bit. Which one?
Yeah, because I was doing the Ingenious Gin.
It's just a lot of not a bit.
Then I need a sip a bit.
Listen, this is black owned champagne.
Always wanted this. I'll have a sip.
Yeah, you can take that to go.
Yeah.
You take that to go.
I want a whole cup.
Mm-hmm. For now. That's what I'm talking about.
Take it down.
Thank you, Mr. Lee. We want the better side of life.
So what was y'all interview y'all wish y'all didn't do?
Which we didn't do?
Yeah. I know you're going to be politically correct right now.
Oh, man.
Easy.
I know. I know because...
Was it gangsta?
It's not address.
On the podcast, right, if you see, like, Flip is the one that's... I'm the one that's kind of like mellow. So a question like that for me is like, to answer that is like tough. But, you know, we here, we drink champs, man.
For being here on drink champs.
This is your drink. It's not your shot. That's your shot. It's your drink. Right. Just be clear. Okay. That's two different things. So go on. Continue. Go ahead, go.
There's an interview we did that couldn't get aired because the guests didn't want to be aired.
Okay, who's that?
Terry Woods.
The author.
The book author.
Yes.
Why?
What did she write? She wrote Black Man.
She wrote True to the Game.
True to the fucking game.
That's the black people. And True to the Game too.
Hear what you about to say.
Go ahead.
I mean, shut up. You asked me which interview we regret that we did.
So she comes on the podcast.
You regret this?
I regret it because we couldn't air it.
Wow. Now, what happened? Tell me what happened.
I think it was a great show. It was a great time.
Right.
After the interview, she called and felt like we asked her crazy questions and she didn't like the questions we asked her.
You could edit whatever she didn't want?
We could have.
All right. Can you give me a example of kind of the crazy questions she
told. Well, we kind of asked a lot of the same questions with all our guests, like, you know, about when it came up and, you know.
Not like Drink Chance, where he's like, did you eat the ass?
Yeah, we asked for the ass. Like, ask, I mean, because I'm going to be honest. I'm not going to ask you
Drink Chance.
I'm not going to ask you if you eat ass. I'm going to be honest. I'm going to pick you tells me you eat a lot of ass. I'm just being honest.
I'm going to pick you eater, so it ain't going to come
but
past.
But you eat ass, though.
I'm going to pick you eater.
But you've ate ass, though.
You eat organic.
Organic ass.
You eat organic ass.
You never ate ass?
I never ate ass before.
I respect
the night is still young.
Whoa, I don't know.
We're in Miami, right?
Continue.
Right, carry on.
No, but John de Taloga,
what is that?
What does that mean?
Come on, you say it with big boy. You know that.
Boy means now.
Good. You're crazy right now.
I think
one of the questions we asked her was, because her whole come up when she was grinding and things like that. So we asked her, did she sleep with anybody on the way up? And she said no. We asked her again. But we do that to all our guests. We asked them questions about their past and who they, you know, who they slept with, who they, you know, did this with, da-da-da. Yeah. But she kind of, but we had a great interview. It was great. We had fun. She left. She was happy. Yeah. But I said I regret it because, like, you know, I feel like I wanted to put that show up. It was a good time. It was a good interview. We had a good time. She felt a way afterwards that we were coming at her and we were, like, kind of, like, talking down.
Let me be the devil's advocate for 1 second. I've been in this game 22 years. No one's ever asked me who I slept with.
And I think asking a woman that is
now,
detrimental.
Here's the crazy. I'm so sorry. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. I'm not trying to
pick you. No, I hear you. Ass.
But I asked her that 3 times.
Right.
This is my sister. Like, and I asked her that 3 times. She didn't even think of that to ask me back.
Well, you didn't ask her that.
No, I asked. No, not asked her directly. I just said, you know, and this is what I'm saying. So you don't think that's like an advantage? Of sometimes, like,
yeah, but like, all right, so
because women like so if I would, what I'm saying is, I would rather come on the Queen's Flip show, y'all, and y'all don't think y'all would ask me that.
Mm. We would,
and why would you ask her that?
No, you wouldn't ask him.
Y'all
don't
ask me who I shot.
It's scandalous. We're gonna ask you.
Y'all don't know who I fucked, so I'm telling you, you would ask me who I shot.
So you say
I know who I shot because I be talking about this shit. I've been watching y'all.
Yeah, yeah.
And then you're talking about who I smuffed and who I pushed and who I everything. So, but you never implied.
So one thing, like you said, you asked me to join that 3 times.
No, I'm just being
No, that's fine. You asked me to join that 3 times, you said.
Yeah.
She won't, I feel like she won't leave here and be like, oh no. Why
in three different ways.
Why
not
he asked me that? Why he try to keep that? He asked 3 times.
Because I know how to do it.
Right. Yeah, but she won't feel the way, though. You know what I'm saying? I don't think she would leave here feeling the way.
But
no, but what I'm saying, I'm talking about when you ask, would you ask homegirl? When you say, yo, I asked you, yo, did you do
she somebody? Actually led into those.
Yes.
She
went before.
No, I'm saying what he said to Terry Woods.
Yeah, yeah.
You said you led into that. You asked her, yo, who, did you sleep with somebody to get to the top?
Right.
Wait, but in those, that's what he said. Those words.
I like that.
And she responded?
She responded. That's why the whole interview was done. We did the whole interview. And we left, and the show's over. She's like, I had a great time. This was dope. Laughing, you know. And then I guess she went home and thought about it. And
no,
was like,
she went home and spoke to somebody.
And they called you back, and they said, don't use it.
Yeah. Can't post it up. Yada, yada, yada.
That's what that is all the time.
I don't appreciate what you guys did. You guys.
Yep. Somebody got in her head.
You guys conduct a bad show, yada, 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 and give us all these bad reviews. Wow, I'm going to phone apologize to her, like, yo.
Wait. The show comes out and they're telling you bad reviews.
Show didn't come out yet.
So how are they telling you bad reviews?
Well, she's saying bad reviews as far as, like, she feels like we don't conduct a good show. We don't ask good questions and things like that. When we already did the whole interview and she told us that she had a good time.
She signed a release?
No. We should sign a release? Nope.
Yeah, but let's get him to sign a release right now. Listen. Be great.
Bye. I'll tell him how she is.
I know you good, sis. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Right, yo, listen. All right, hold on. Relax. I got about 5 more minutes.
But that's deep, though. You know what I mean?
Yeah, nah, that's real deep.
And it happens sometimes. Like I said, faith.
It happens all the time.
Faith.
Men and women.
I was
it's not just
stuff
women.
With faith, and she was sharing stuff with me. So I was, even though that question I asked her was a little distasteful, she knew it was a joke.
Right.
She was surprised that I wasn't more Jonesy with her.
Right.
But I feel like that was Stevie J more so. So you don't know, and you would not have known, if it was an outside influence that after the fact said, fall back, sis, don't let that interview come out.
Yo, I love it, man. This is great content, man. I can't even ask no more questions. This is great.
Dale un foto.
Dale foto.
Dale foto.
That's it. That's all we need. Yo, this is fucking great.